Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Just tell us what you're looking for and we'll make you a deal. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
Only Saracen Casino gives away a brand new car every month. And not just any cars, but the hottest cars on the road. Like for April, a Porsche 718 Boxster from Gossett Porsche in Memphis. You need to be driving a super cool Porsche Roadster, and you can. It's easy. Just play your favorite casino games and rack up entries, but only at Saracen Casino Resort.
Saracen Casino Resort, Vegas, Arkansas style.
Gambling problem? Call 800-GAMBLER.
Roger Scott for Gravely Mowers. You know, when it comes to beautiful lawns, nothing cuts like a Gravely. And when it comes to cutting prices, there's nothing like the Gravely Mow the Distance sales event, where you can save up to 25%. And special financing is available on America's most rugged and dependable mowers, including their ZT-HD. It's the residential mower built to commercial standards. But hurry, because the Mow the Distance sale is only through April 8th and only at your authorized Gravely dealers like Triple C Sales and Service in Conway or Lawn and Power in Star City.
Clayton Homes of Conway is moving. But until then, you can find them at their location on East Dave Ward Drive, where you're invited to stop by on April 12th and 13th for their inventory reduction sale. Save thousands of dollars on in-stock inventory of homes. Lenders will be available for all your financing questions. There'll be door prizes, food, fun, and entertainment for the whole family. April 12th and 13th at Clayton Homes of Conway.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency on earth. And if you owe back taxes, the news isn't good. The IRS is raising the interest rate it charges on unpaid taxes, and further rate hikes are expected. Most people don't know it, but the IRS adds interest charges on your tax debt daily. So if you owe the IRS today, you will owe even more tomorrow. And it doesn't stop until you get right with the IRS. The good news is, getting right can start with one phone call to Optima Tax Relief, America's number one tax relief firm. Optima's tax professionals specialize in the Fresh Start Initiative, a powerful IRS program that can save you thousands if you qualify. In fact, the experts at Optima Tax have resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients. Call now for a free consultation.
Call 800-480-6932. That's 800-480-6932. 800-480-6932.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. Steve Sullivan, KATV Channel 7 in Little Rock. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Buzz Radio Network studios here in the heart of the state of Arkansas, the capital city. Good afternoon, Mr. Rick Schaefer. Good afternoon, Mr. Steve Sullivan.
Hey, good afternoon. We're getting calls to station. Has Mus left yet? How did we get to this point this quickly? I remember him at the end of the SEC tournament when they were eliminated, and he said, I can't wait to get back to work. And everybody's excited that he was so motivated. And I don't know where this thing went south, but this is crazy now. I mean,
He just said he wanted to get back to work. He didn't say where.
He hasn't said a word either, too. You know,
no,
and
he hadn't.
It's crazy right now, and I don't like coaching searches, so I like whatever what I have here and now, and I've got the guy that went to, you know, three straight Sweet 16s, but if he's not all bought in, then, you know, then it's time to move on.
I would say this, Steve, and we've said this week, if he went to Los Angeles, he needs to get the job while he's there, because while we all sometimes don't like change so much, probably 50% of the fan base has turned on him already, if not more than that. If you're going to leave Arkansas to go interview for a job, people don't accept that, because what they want is they want a coach that belongs to them. If you're going to do that, you better not tell anybody about it. You know how these things work with search agencies and all that kind of stuff. If he wants a USC job, or if USC wants him and it's not already a done deal, you meet in Montana, or you meet in Phoenix, or you meet somewhere where nobody even knows you're there.
Yeah, this
and
is...
you talk it over. To say you're going to L.A. to interview for a job, and they say, then you've got to go and take it. You can't go in there and say, well, I'm one of three candidates, or, gosh, this place is a dump. I'm not coming. You can't do that.
Hey, this is really bizarre. Can you remember the last time someone like him scheduled an interview so publicly? It's almost like in the
Never.
Face of your athletic director.
Never.
I mean, it's... It's like you say, and I've been amazed, too, just on social media. And you can't use Twitter or X as a true barometer of how the fans feel, but it gives you kind of a feel of what's going on. And I've been amazed how quickly, like you say, people have turned on Mus.
Because here's the way most people think. If you don't want to be here, then leave.
Yeah.
That's why. It has nothing to do with his record. It has nothing to do with this last season. People realize, hey, you've won, what, 8 NCAA tournament games in 3 years? Okay, you get a down year. That's fine. Rebuild. Nobody, I don't think there's many people upset about that. I mean, there's a fringe that they don't like if you lose a game. But that's it.
Hey,
nobody
where do you think it turned with him, though?
From the end
of the SEC tournament to now.
Now.
When people heard he was looking for another job. That's where it turned.
Well, let's back up, because what we were told yesterday by Kevin McPherson, that after year number two, Musselman has been, quote, looking around.
So nobody knew that. Yeah. I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either. Yeah. But the point of it is, okay, if it dates back that far, so what has been going on that has brought this desire to move on,
hey, and the
to look around.
And the reality is he had his contract structured like few coaches in America. He negotiated for freedom rather than, going over the top with money, where it's unheard of. You have a coach with a $1 million buyout that the other school has to pay.
Sure. Yeah.
And I think that's because of his background. The guy doesn't stay anywhere more than 3 or 4 years, and it was an opportunity for him after each year to evaluate. And I never felt like there was any hint in the previous 4 years of him doing anything but, when the season ended, building for the next year.
Right.
And,
that's right.
But something went wrong this year. You know, when you're winning, it kind of covers all sins. But something went wrong this year that caused him, you know, outside of the 15 and 16 record, to look elsewhere. And I, and USC may be appealing. It's a West Coast job, but it's, you're not relevant as far as fans, 4,500. You're not about 4,500 average they had last year. And you're not relevant in the sports scene. And here's a guy who loves to be the big man on campus. I mean, he has really enjoyed being coach of the University of Arkansas.
And where does basketball rank on that scale at USC?
Yeah, what would cause him to jump at this job outside of it's a West Coast job?
That's it. You know, that because you think about it, doesn't his mom still live in San Diego?
She lives in San Diego. What is that, about 75 to 125 miles away?
Yeah. Which means it's a 12-hour drive.
And money doesn't go as far.
I know the neighborhood he lives in Northwest Arkansas. I can just tell you that to buy a house like he currently owns will cost him at least 4, maybe 5 times what he paid for it here, to get a house that size in Los Angeles.
Yeah, and some coaches.
But if you make that much money, what difference does it make, right?
And some coaches, you know, the spotlight is okay and they enjoy it. I think it's a must for Mus. That he likes to be the guy, and he has loved it as far as, you know, the adoration of Razorback fans and the selling the Mus bus stuff. And I really thought, you know, after you try to think when you have a coach, what is his end goal? And I thought his was being a great college coach and getting to the Final Four, and he's been one win away twice. And I just am really surprised that he's going to dump it for USC.
Well, here's the one thing this tells you that we should know every day. We don't know how everybody thinks.
In fact, that's right.
We don't know how anybody thinks except us, unless somebody tells us how they're thinking. And he obviously has not said anything to anybody. You know, we don't want to create anything between he and Hunter. We don't know about that.
Yeah, it can't be a great relationship when you have that. That bus video just really bothered me.
That is beyond bizarre.
That was a crazy thing. What was he thinking? I don't know.
Yeah, why wouldn't you? How could you not contact Bus and then let it hang out there where people like me had the perception, and I went on the air and said this, that I thought all things were well and Bus is here to stay. And that sat for a couple of days until he did, you know, someone leaked out to McPherson that, you know, Musk was unhappy with the video and had no part of the video. But that was just totally bizarre, and that indicated to me that their relationship had got to a point where they weren't really talking about serious things, you know, that he had to communicate through that bus video.
Maybe so. There are things that we're never going to know.
Yeah.
We're never going to know what it was like in the locker room, because the only people that could tell us would be the coaches or the players, and we suspect neither will ever say much, maybe through friends. You know, we get into these discussions with Kevin McPherson, who obviously has sources that we don't have. We have sources that he doesn't have. There was disagreement on those sources. He's saying all along Musk was going to leave. If no job had opened in California, would he leave? It's interesting that the coach that left USC to go to SMU had coached, I guess, either four or five teams had made it to the NCAA, but this past year they were 15-18. So SMU just hired a coach that was 15-18. So I don't guess USC would have any problem with a 16-17 coach, because he'd won so well in the NCAA 3 years before that. But it's just all a crazy thing. And, you know, the thing you have to say is, we, residents of Arkansas, those who have covered the Razorbacks for years, believe the University of Arkansas is a pretty good place to be.
Yeah.
It's not a final destination for some people. I think that's one thing. You know, we can say what we want about Sam Pittman, the seasons he's had the last couple of years. This is the only job he wants. He don't want another job. So we hope he does it well next year, because we love hearing that from coaches who are at the school where you cover them.
I don't think anybody expected, when Musk came to Arkansas, looking at what he had done in the past, that it'd be a forever job for him. But I just think I really believe his end goal is not money. It's being thought of as a great college coach, and that's going to the Final Four and having a chance to win a national championship. And when you've been twice in 5 years, one win away from that title, and you know, if you finish eighth in that Final Four, if you finish eighth or ninth in the SEC, you're probably going to get to the NCAA tournament. And
he's probably thinking the same thing in the Big Ten. Next year's USC's first year in the Big Ten.
Can you imagine, though?
That's a splash. I don't know.
This guy is, we've seen it. He has incredible ups and downs. Can you imagine losing maybe at Michigan State on a Thursday, and then Piscataway on a Saturday, and then getting in a plane and going back with him to USC? He complained about some of the trips this year in the SEC about, you know, having...
Oh, my gosh. How about going to Rutgers?
About weekly, and now you're going to go into that.
Yeah.
How about
Rutgers? How about Penn State from L.A.? Won't that be fun?
And it's a different animal. And, I mean, you are not the big man on campus with...
No, because football's always going to be. But, and here, football's big, but basketball... when you're doing well is
high. Yeah, well,
baseball.
Who was the
look how big baseball is right now. So there's room for plenty. It's not just a one sport place.
And the NIL has changed too, with the later you lose a coach, the worse shape you're in as a program.
Yeah.
You know, and we've got four guys that are semi committed, you know, and they're committed maybe to Musk. I don't know if they're committed to the University of Arkansas. We'll find out soon. But if he leaves
the day if they, and again, USC needs to announce him as coach today or tomorrow.
Yeah.
And it'd be great if Hunter Yurecek announced a coach Friday or Saturday. Now, they don't like you to do it when the Final Four is going on, so if you can't do it Friday, you got to wait till Tuesday. But wouldn't it be great if he could announce that coach that quick? And you would hope he's working on it.
Well, you got to imagine he has a list. I mean, you know, and you hear the names, and, you know, a lot of guys have been, like, Chris Beard, I heard someone said he hadn't signed his extension, but he's agreed to an extension at Ole Miss. And Lamont Parrish, the South Carolina coach, has a new contract that pays him like $4.6 million. You wonder.
There are a lot of good coaches. The question is, who can get talent to the University of Arkansas? They've got a great arena to recruit to. We have no idea what the NIL situation is.
That is the key.
Yeah, except there are a lot of schools that played in the NCAA tournament this year that probably didn't have a lot for NIL, and they still got players to come.
I'm just telling you, in today's SEC game,
I get it.
NIL is the key.
I get it, but how many good basketball players are out there, some of whom don't go to the schools where they have big NILs?
You know what's been wild in the NCAA tournament is to see the number of players, and you got to pick the right one, like a Dalton Connect, that come from the smaller schools. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can miss on some.
Sure.
But if you look at Arkansas's best teams, you know, you had the Jalen Tate and the Amude. They weren't from the biggest schools, you know, and you get the right fit. And there's so many of those guys in the portal that won't demand the high number. And I think our NIL is better than people think. I mean, you look at football and look at the recruits we're getting from the schools, Alabama, Georgia, LSU. Muss has really never had a problem getting players to Fayetteville. Every recruiting class he's had has been top-ranked. And baseball, look at that lineup. You know, they're littered with transfers, and good transfers.
All right, gentlemen, let's get busy with our phones. We got callers waiting.
I'm sure we do.
Sterling, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Good afternoon. This Sean, he got the name wrong. But how you doing, Randy, Rick, and Steve?
Good.
Hello, Sterling.
No, it's Sean, but it's okay.
It's Sean. Well, I got Sterling on my screen. My bad.
That's okay. I know people don't really want to talk about it, but something happened in the middle of that season this year, and I believe the freedom that you talked about, because he only got a $1 million buyout, is because he had wanted freedom. And something happened. I think he was forced to do something that he didn't want to do, because that team had kind of gelled together after something had happened in the middle of the season. And they were playing better than he was forced. I think he was forced to bring some people back that he didn't want to. And that took away his freedom. And at that point, I felt like in the season that Muscle was going to leave. I wish he wouldn't, because I think he's a great coach. And with the right talent, he can team against anybody in the world.
Can you ask you what do you mean he was forced to bring somebody back? What do you think? What are you saying there?
I'm just gonna say us growing up, because I'm 51, and when we were growing up, if a player left the team,
You think he was forced to take him back? Wow, that's an interesting thought.
I think he was forced to take him back. And that right there took away his freedom, and he didn't like that. Because his demeanor kind of changed after that.
You know, it's interesting you would say that. Interesting you would say that, because we were all baffled that he would take him back and not sit him on the bench for a while after, and we thought the decision was his, so I never even considered that somebody told him he had to bring him back. What makes you think that?
I kind of consider it like when Houston with Mitch Mustang.
Yeah.
It was sort of the same thing. Oh,
wow. Interesting. That's an interesting thought. Thank you.
One thing I'm pretty sure of that Mus had the keys to that basketball program, and he made every major decision. I mean, and there was some things he stopped doing that previous coaches were doing because he wanted to do them differently, as far as media responsibilities. And sometimes winning gives you the right, you know, to do even more than probably the previous coach was doing. And I think he exercised that right. And I think that's one thing he demanded, is, you know, that he had the keys to that program and he made every decision. Even to the NIL, where, you know, he kind of went outside the lines and developed the relationship with the Hunt family.
I'm sure they're going to be pleased that he leaves. No, I mean, you develop those kind of relationships. You say, I need your help, and then you leave.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, and that's a, you know, it's a, you know, with these coaches are taking care of themselves. I mean, that's a, and it's just a, this whole thing, the way it's went down has been bizarre. Just this past 3 or 4 weeks.
Rick, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Well, hey, I sure didn't mean to have to call in on this this day with Muzz, because I really love the guy, and I think, you know, his whole family works around Razorback basketball, and his whole family. But, you know, I have an inside kid that is a low salary guy. I've been there for that I had at Bryant, and he said, I told y'all a little bit earlier in the season that I thought that he might want to leave for the West Coast. And, of course, I got tore up, but that's okay. But I think he did a good job for us. And the next guy, he won't never be, even if he don't take this job or he gets turned down, he won't have no credibility here in Arkansas. No more. Even if he don't get offered this job, it's going to be a sad situation because the fans and the NIL, you go looking for another job, you know, just like Eddie did. You know, everybody turned off on Eddie when I was a kid. He was going to crawl to Kentucky.
What
and that turned us off. But it all got, over the years, it all got back straightened out.
Right.
That's my comment today, guys. I'm just so sorry about this.
Well, you had nothing to do with it, so you don't
need
to
feel
sorry about it. You know, we can say, sorry it happened, but none of us had anything to do with it.
All right, let's talk with Blake. Blake, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Hey, guys. I want to put it a little bit different perspective on this Musselman situation.
Sure.
Unfortunately, the world we're in right now, it's changed. Everybody on the radio right now is very old school, very loyal people. But with the transfer portal and NIL, things have changed these days. You know, a lot of people are saying they wouldn't welcome us back, but we wanted Bobby Petrino back. Yes, he didn't leave, but he got fired. But if he would have went to Louisville and then came back in the same situation, I'm sure that we would have had some kind of reaction with our arms wide open. And the other four kids that are still on the team right now, we got to be foolish if we don't think that they're out there filling out other schools they could go to.
Well, of course.
Social media.
Well, of course.
So I think this is the day and age we're in these days. It's not something that, you know, it's going to be a revolving door for most head coaches 5 to 6 years from here on out.
And if that's the case, that's the case. And you're right. You just have to adjust to it. That's it.
But I do think, you know, with just like everything else in this world, you know, he wouldn't, just because he wouldn't interview somewhere, I think if he doesn't get it, we should be more than welcome to accept him back. That's my personal opinion, guys. Thank you so much. You'll have a great day.
Thank you,
Blake. Well, the reality is, I think if he wants to come back, he can come back because he has a contract to, 2026?
Yeah.
You know,
no, through 28. He's got four more years.
Yeah. So, I mean, if it doesn't work out at USC and Arizona State may have an opening too. So, he's quiet now, and it wouldn't have been so public, and he has something set up out there.
Oh, it's. I will be the first, and I'll say it again. You do not make the trip to L.A. unless you're dotting the T's.
Yeah.
Or dotting the I's, I should say, and crossing the T's, and then deciding where you want to live. Because you don't do this to the job that you have back in Arkansas unless you already have is the bird already in hand.
Registration is open for the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course, presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka.
Birch Tree Communities, providing care for individuals living with severe mental illness in their own supervised home environment. Their staff serves as a guide to members on their journey to independence in the community. If you have a client, friend, or loved one diagnosed with schizophrenia, schizoaffective or bipolar disorder, and are in need of assisted residential care, please contact Birch Tree Community's Admissions Department or online at birchtree.org. Birch Tree Communities, a place called home.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at alcoacommunityfcu.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties.
Clint Sterner here for Low T Center. Fellas, if you've been feeling tired and grumpy, maybe you've noticed a lack of motivation and drive, a little weight gain, loss of muscle mass, these could all be signs of low testosterone levels. It happens. It's not if, it's when. The key, fellas, is that you address the issue. At Low T Center, it's easy to get your levels checked. We're talking a simple blood test with results back in about 25 minutes. Low T Center, it's not your typical doctor's office, no sir. It's concierge medicine for all of us men. They're physicians. They specialize in treating low testosterone with customized treatments for each patient. Most health insurance is accepted for treatment, and they have affordable and convenient treatment options, including physician-monitored self-inject treatments for established patients. Those treatments, they ship directly to your home each and every month, so there's no need to drive to the center for weekly visits. Right now, Low T Center, it's only $25 to get your T levels tested with the results back in 25 minutes. Make your health and quality of life a priority and go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment today. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's health care.
The $79 garage door tune-up extended through April. Is your garage door too loud? Is it whining for attention? Overhead Door Company of Little Rock will make it all better. They'll perform their garage door tune-up and safety inspection for just $79 extended through April. That's just $79 for up to three garage doors and openers. You need this done once a year, so why not now and for just $79? Schedule now at overheaddoorofLittleRock.com.
The Powerball jackpot from the Arkansas Scholarship Lottery is now more than $1 billion. So, what would you do if you won?
I'd buy a baseball team.
Ooh, I would definitely buy my mom a Tesla so that she can drive cool, look cool.
If I won a jackpot, I'll start a cooking school for the youth in the city.
Got your ticket? If not, visit your local lottery retailer for your chance to win the Powerball jackpot of more than $1 billion. This is winning. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
Now, back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish studios. Eat fresh, eat local, eat my catfish. The number one sports radio show in Arkansas, Drive Time Sports, on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports here on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, Steve Sully Sullivan.
I'm Randy Rainwater.
I wonder if we have any callers. Should I just spend a few moments just responding or at least trying to get in some of the either live feed feedback or the Buzz text line real quick before we go back to our phone lines? Okay, let's see. Where do I start? There's so much. This from Brian Hot Springs. He says, "Woo PS to Mus leaving or staying. Grateful for his time. Hope he stays. Once a hog, always a hog." Nick, I will not read that one because I do not want us to think that we are playing one way or the other towards anything that has happened otherwise between ourselves and some of the segments recently by Kevin McPherson, so I won't read that one. Let's see. JR says, having the 12th or 13th ranked NIL program in the SEC for our basketball team, I'm sure has played a lot into Mus looking around.
And how do we know that's true? Nobody knows that's true.
Let's see. This from the 501. Guys, it's just Arkansas. We love our state, but it ain't for city folks, especially Cali family. Cali houses really don't mean much after you have reached that level. Okay, stop making Hunter out to be bad, Sully. Stop. Go after Beard or Bama's coach. Ask a bigger basketball school than Bama. Okay. Let's see. This from the 501. Why is it okay for a person in the private sector to explore other job opportunities? And if they don't pan out, they don't get fired or run off. Why in coaching is that not acceptable? Hey, Justin! Justin, I'm going to go interview for a job tomorrow in radio. I just wanted you to know real quick before I do that. Hey, Justin, is that okay?
Hey, well, Hunter Urechek did it the right way, according to Wally Hall, because Wally Hall, in his column today, said Hunter was one of three finalists for the Texas A&M job.
Did you know that? I'd heard of that.
But Rick said that that's doing it the right way. You do. No one knows.
Yeah, nobody knows about it. That's right.
So when it comes out, people say, oh, he didn't get the job. You know, and I don't see any hate for Hunter now for going for that.
I didn't know that he went for it.
Yeah, well, apparently he was a finalist. Yeah.
Well, you know, and that's why I guess the thing is hard for those of us who do still believe in loyalty, and I know that that's not the case in a lot of people. If all you look at is money, then I can tell you, you will never be satisfied. You can go and have good jobs and do some good things, but if that's what your pursuit is, so I think at Texas A&M, they've got more money than just about anybody, except Ohio State, because A&M's AD left Texas A&M to go to Ohio State. Now, the thing you'd have to say is, and Ohio State, I believe, has the biggest athletic budget in the United States, and Texas is second, and A&M's right up there close, too. But Ohio State, it does have the number one athletic budget in the United States. So he left probably a top five for number one. Now, maybe he left also because he might have gotten some flack from people that didn't like the fact that they're paying a football coach $70 million not to coach. So at least at Ohio State, he doesn't have that problem. So now A&M, of course the guy hadn't beaten Michigan 3 years in a row. So some of their fans, even though they win 10 or 11 every year, they don't like him because he doesn't beat Michigan. Mm-hmm. So now you got the A&M job open with that much money. Well, if NIL is a factor at Arkansas, and again, you're talking about a state of 3 million people and you're trying to sell tickets, have contributions, and now you want the same people to pay for NIL, I can see why you might want to go somewhere where there's a lot more money. Makes your job easier. But does that make it a better job? I don't know. I don't think so.
Hey, we signed
those that think so.
Our basketball program signed some highly sought-after transfers. You talk LLS averaged like 18 for Louisville.
Cliff Battle, was a big scorer.
Temple.
Mark.
Menifield for Washington. Starter on Houston, Tremont. Mark, you don't think they spent some money on transfers? And one thing, too, when you rely heavily on transfers, like the football program and basketball, your total goes up. You know, like I think one of the big things this year in LSU is Brian Kelly thinks he's got to a point where he doesn't have to use the portal much. So he has, I think, 7 portal players out of his entire roster. And Houston's the same way in basketball. They don't have a lot of portal players, but your entire cost of your NIL program goes up year to year, and it goes up if you keep relying solely on that portal. But basketball, I think he's got a pretty good situation where he's had a lot of transfers in highly rated classes every year. So I don't think that's the issue.
This real quick, this football, talking football, transfer portal, Alabama has 9, Arkansas 14, Auburn 9, Florida 11, Georgia 9, Kentucky 10, LSU 7, Mississippi State 16, Missouri 12, Oklahoma 13, Ole Miss 18, South Carolina 20, Tennessee 8, Texas 8, Texas A&M 23, Vanderbilt 12.
Well, at Texas A&M, it just shows you now, when you change a coach, what happens to your roster. I mean, that was a school that didn't use many before when Jimbo was coaching. He went all basically freshman and got beaten that way. But when you change a coach, especially in football, in this NIL world, it is dramatic. I mean, traumatic as far as what happens to your program. And basketball, we're about to see it. If indeed Musk takes the USC job, what kind of roster this new coach has to work with?
Probably zero. But when you go back to A&M specifically, Steve, though, the two previous years to that, that number one recruiting class that they bought, they had lost a bunch of already. So, I mean, they had already been experiencing turnover in that roster, even in Jimbo's last couple of years. Let's talk to Craig. Craig, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Good afternoon, Mr. Double R.
What's
Mr.
up, buddy?
Kelly. Not much. I just wanted to take a – I don't have any inside sources. I know you have people that do. I just want to look eastward from Catalina Island and say maybe the big reason is out there, and I'm not talking about his mom because, I mean, he can fly to see her anytime he wants to. How about the fact that Bronny James is the third biggest name they've had in about 40 years out there, counting Paul Westfall and O.J. Mayo, and maybe he's on the short list from, say, LeBron or Bronny of coaches that will keep Bronny there. I don't know. Just speculation. I will say this about transfer portal. Most of those student-athletes come with a chip on their shoulder. Now, is it the quitter chip? Or is it, I'm going to prove you wrong, Chip? Hello?
Yeah, we're just letting that sink in.
Which do they come with? I don't know.
Well, I mean, they come with a chip. Everybody does. I mean, they come with baggage, metaphor you want to use.
Oh, you're talking about out of the transfer portal?
I don't think
that. Right. I mean, they were unhappy. They don't transfer because they're happy.
Yeah.
I don't know. There's a lot of starting players that are jumping in the portal, at least according to what I'm reading.
Yeah.
And a lot of these guys, I think, are strictly doing it for marketing purposes. How much more can I get
in a short?
I'm just saying though, it's not because of lack of playing time or lack of success. They're flexing their marketing muscle.
Hey, statistically, it's a bundle of six.
If you looked at last year's basketball recruiting class, I mean, those stats were off the charts for those guys. We thought, you know, you mix them in with Brazil and the guys we had coming back and Devo, we're going to have quite the roster. I mean, on paper, it looked awesome when you seen the guards and the points they put up.
All right, we'll touch on a little bit more of our Let's get to the live fan feedback. Marianne says, here we go, Rick. Dana Altman took our job for a couple of hours, then went back to Creighton. They took him back. It does happen. We just have our feelings hurt. Rick, not everything is as absolute like you try to make it.
Well, now that there's probably truth in that. But it was amazing that Creighton took him back. And I wonder... He found out Creighton would take him back before he told Arkansas he was leaving, by the way. So you better make sure you got a job. None of us pretend to know the conversations Hunter Yurecek and Eric Musselman have had. We don't know. If he leaves, we don't know if it'll be revealed by either one of them. Why he left, we don't know. So all you can do is speculate a little bit, but I can tell you this. When a coach flirts with another job, and we've had some nice supportive calls tonight, but most of your fan base says, good luck, go somewhere else. And if they come back, it is a much more difficult thing to come back to.
You know, just from what we've seen, you know, as far as Hunter with the video, first the bus, and then the video and the podcast, is he's had very little communication, if any, with Mus since the, you know, since the season ended, and that's not a good thing. I mean, it's a
because they'd have a year-end review.
Hey, they're at a point as a program. They're making a push now with Arkansas Edge. They need all coaches. They need a unified front, and your basketball coach is out there, and he's not fully committed in the middle of it. This is a guy that lives in the portal. I mean, he's on that portal. He's seeing every recruit that comes in during the season, and this is his time. And he's taking time away to, you know, to jet out to watch. And he's probably going to go to the Final Four.
Yeah, it could.
But nothing's good when you lose. I mean, when you don't meet expectations, everybody's miserable. When you have a season like this, was a historically bad season that you finished below 500. You missed every postseason. You didn't even qualify for postseason play as far as the NIT or the NCAA tourney. And, you know, in things that were you got away with when you were winning, when you have a season like that, it could be program shaking. And I think that's what we're seeing here.
Let's talk to Mike. Mike, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Good afternoon. I guess my question might be directed a little bit more toward Rick since he worked at the university. Do you know how it works for Musselman to go for the interview? Does he have to call in sick or have to go sit down and talk to Hunter Yurecek?
I'm guessing he has plenty of vacation time.
How does that go about?
Yeah, I'm sure he has plenty of vacation time. Yeah, he can just say, "Hey, I'm taking three of my days off." He doesn't have to tell him why.
Well, he's told everybody. He can tell him why now. Everybody knows.
And someone has to foot the bill besides the university to fly him out there.
Well, USC would be paying.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Thank you, Mike. All right, we will step aside for a moment. Rick Schaefer, Steve Sullivan. I'm Randy Rainwater. It's amazing how fast time passes when you're here, Sully.
Yes.
Just boom, boom, boom. Drive Time Sports will continue in just one moment.
Coach Kevin Kelly joins the Zone each Wednesday, presented by Wooden Rock Athletic Club. The indoor pickleball facility is now open. Join the club today and save 30% off joining fees.
Save the date for the Luxury Pool & Spa annual sale the week of April 15th at their Conway and Russellville locations. 20% off store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, spas at truckload pricing, and rebates on pool chemicals, plus over $12,000 in giveaways during the annual Luxury Pool & Spa sale the week of April 15th.
Is your Oaklawn Thoroughbred racing action so close you can feel it? Or is it the view from your trackside luxury suite? However you like it, racing season is off and running at Oaklawn with live races every weekend through May 4th. It's fun by the furlong all season long. Make your reservations today at oaklawn.com. What's your Oaklawn? Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700.
Again, sent bead story. Jim was at the laundromat when he heard his ear said, "Maracas, senor," but his nose said, "Hey, freshest scent ever." Following his nose, Jim found a man pouring a bottle of Gain scent beads into the washer. The scent, the freshness. Jim blurted, "Sir, your scent maracas smell amazing." Actually, Jim, most noses call them Gain scent beads. Try Gain scent beads, way fresher than detergent alone.
I'm Tiffany, founder of Harlem Pilates. When I couldn't find Pilates in my neighborhood, I started a studio from my studio apartment. Chase Inc. helped me grow from one Pilates studio to three. Because when you start small, you're going to need some big help.
With the Chase Inc. Business Cash Card, you can earn up to 5% cash back on business essentials, so your business can go from here to possible. Chase for Business. Make more of what's yours. Real business owner compensated for their participation. Cards issued by JPMorgan Chase Bank, NA member FDIC, subject to credit approval. Terms apply.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor, appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more. At the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
There are no ordinary days in Arkansas. Hike to inspiring summits, bike on world-class trails, or fish in sparkling waters. Or see some of the world's top art collections and explore historic sites dedicated to everything from civil rights to rock and roll. After that, eat some award-winning barbecue and sip a local craft beer. So go on, get out there, and explore what the natural state has to offer. Find out more at arkansas.com.
Fence Brokers presents Razorback Graffiti every Monday morning. Call Morning Mayhem and let them know how you feel about how they did. One sentence and one sentence only.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish studios, where it's much like any of the seven Eat My Catfish locations, minus the always fresh, delicious food options like the family pack catfish dinners. The number one sports radio show in Arkansas, Drive Time Sports, on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, Steve Sullivan. I'm Randy Rainwater, joined now by Neil Atkinson by way of Bet Saracen. What is going on, Neil? I know it's quiet times there at Bet Saracen, isn't it?
No, it's never quiet times. We've got Major League Baseball in play every day. We got NIT in the Final Four going on, or a lot of stuff going on. And, of course, college baseball. And we got the double R props for tomorrow's matchup against Ole Miss. And we've got the early money lineup. Arkansas is a minus 350 on the money line. I would guess if we did a 1 point. Yeah, so they're heavily favored in that one there. We'll see what the run line populates and what the over and under is going to be. Yesterday when we put up the line, we kind of did that ourselves, and we did okay. Game ended on the run rule, so 13-0. I think we had a 17.5 over and under on that one. And Arkansas favored, and of course they covered that one easily. And then again, interesting action coming in on the NCAA men's tournament. The early money are taking the Wolfpack against the Boilermakers, taking the plus 9.5, and a lot of people are taking Alabama plus 11.5 against UConn. So that was kind of interesting and not anticipated. And we each actually have a pretty good liability on the North Carolina State Wolfpack money line, getting plus 350 on that one. So that's kind of still a little early. Most of those bets won't come in until Saturday, but it was interesting seeing the early money going with the Dogs.
What have you got on the women's Final Four? Have you got that one up yet?
Let me see if we've got that one up yet. We should have it right here. And the women's Final Four is posted. Where is it? It just popped down. You have South Carolina is 11.5-point favorite over NC State Wolfpack, and the Iowa Hawkeyes are a 2.5-point favorite over UConn. Now, one thing, we have both NC State and Connecticut are both in the Final Four of the men's and women's tournament. Make sure you are betting the right one. Look for the W for the women.
Ah, good point.
That does not mean automatic winner. And I can claim I was betting on the wrong one now. We've already had a few kind of try that one. But, yeah, make sure when you're betting on UConn or the Wolfpack in the NCAA tournament, you know the difference between the men's and the women's market.
Good point. Now, I would not go against Connecticut ladies after watching that game the other day against USC. That was a gutty effort. I didn't realize until listening to the broadcast – how many players that Connecticut has lost to injury, and then they got into foul problems. I mean, that was a gutty victory the other day. All right, Neil, so where can someone get in on all this good stuff?
Go to BetSaracen.com on the web, or better yet, from your phone, where 95% of the people place their bets is either on an Apple or Android. Go either to the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store, type in Bet Saracen. In as little as 5 minutes, you can go through the registration, download, and be placing your first bet on your favorite team or player. And you don't have to sign up. You can look at all the specials and all the odds. And I got a feeling if you see them, you'll want to sign up and get in on the action, especially with how well the Hogs are doing in baseball and all the tournament action this weekend. It's going to be sad not to have college basketball after this weekend, but it is a great time of the year.
All right, Neil. We will talk with you tomorrow. That is Neil Atkinson by way of Bet Saracen. Go online at BetSaracen.com. Better yet, go get the app in the App Store. Let's talk with Brent. Brent, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Good afternoon, Randy.
Hey, what's up, Brent? What's up, buddy?
Not much to it. Steve, we need to, I bet Bo Whittle could tell you what's going to happen because Bo Whittle scored 75 touchdowns.
A blast from the past, the Friday night touchdowns past.
But I've got to say, this is going on way too long. And I just can't believe Hunter Yurecek, how far he outstepped his bound with that video. Come on. I mean, that shows me right there. Our basketball and our athletic director is crumbling at the seams.
Well,
hello.
I still don't understand why he did what he did either with that.
Yeah.
And I understand there could be some embedded things in there that we don't quite understand at this particular point in time, maybe.
But they let it go so long before telling us it was re-edited.
Yeah.
I mean, I want to point out something Rick said earlier, and he hit the nail on the head there about Arkansas and how it's different than other states, the fans and the passion they have and how much they dump into the program. And it's important, and you mentioned it, and part of the reason they bought Sam Pittman at the beginning was because it was genuine, his love for Arkansas.
Mm-hmm.
And Rick mentioned a great thing. When Muss openly flirted and put USC out there, that's when it changed on Arkansas. That was a great point because when you look at his record, Jeff Goodman, a national writer, was wondering how could it flip so quickly on Muss? And it didn't flip until, you know, he went out there publicly and you don't see that happen. I can't remember the last coach that was so public with going for a job like Muss has been with USC.
No, I don't. It's never happened in Arkansas. When Ken Hatfield left and went to Clemson, nobody knew he was going to do that.
Yeah. No, that was bizarre. That was out of nowhere.
Right. And then I'm trying to think of other coaches who have left. Eddie Sutton evidently was not Kentucky's first choice, but when he got the job, nobody knew he was even talking to Kentucky. Kentucky did not even call Coach Broyles for permission to talk to him. I'm not sure people do that anymore, but they did then. And so he left without anybody realizing he was about to leave. I'm trying to think about other coaching changes. Who else has left? Yeah,
I'll tell you something about Muss, too, and something he said to me personally in a message one time, and it was after a big win, and he said, there's no better place in America to be a coach when you're doing well than Arkansas. I mean, and I think he really appreciated the passion of the fans here. And that's,
I think so.
And he had built something special with the students, and that kind of surprises me. And but like you say, we don't know what went on behind the scenes this year, and it's going to be highly dysfunctional when you have a year like he had. Because hey, he never thought in his wildest dreams he'd have a year where he was under 500, and he didn't even make the NCAA tournament. That wasn't even on his scope.
No.
And we don't know how he reacted behind the scenes to that, or you know what the university was saying, and maybe it is time for him to go.
All right, let's finish up on this Buzz text line post. Says, why is it okay for a person in the private sector to explore other job opportunities if they don't pan out, they don't get fired or run off? Why in coaching is that not acceptable?
In a lot of businesses, and Randy teased about this, in a lot of businesses, if they know you are interviewing for another job and it's not a major step up, if it's a step up, people usually, hey, if you're an assistant coach, the head coach wants you to become a head coach.
That's exactly right. You're right.
But if you're at the top of the food chain, you are at the top of the food chain, and you talk to another company, no matter what business are you in, usually the company that you're going to interview with or from says, you better get the job because you're not going to be here anymore. So that is a fact of life in business. Yeah.
This is such a high-profile job, too. I mean, he's such a big personality in the state, and there's probably no bigger personality on that campus than Muss. And you just wish, like he said, it'd be over. Just let's get it done and move on.
And think about this. As you look at rivalry, I think Holtz and Sutton had a little bit of rivalry because both of them were big personalities, and Sutton wanted basketball to be number one, and Holtz definitely wanted football to be number one.
Hey, I guarantee you.
If Musselman goes to USC, right now he's at a school where the football coach has a very low profile. He's just a regular guy. USC, he's out there with the glamour of the football program.
Yeah.
And basketball is definitely not number one there.
Yeah, one thing you have now, the coach is competing for dollars in the NIL, which will make their relationship even tougher.
Sure.
Yeah.
Good point there. All right, Steve.
Hey, thank you much.
I know you have another job to get to.
Enjoy you guys. I was enlightened today.
A brand new car every month, and not just any cars, but the hottest cars on the road. Like for April, a Porsche 718 Boxster from Gossett Porsche in Memphis. You need to be driving a super cool Porsche Roadster, and you can. It's easy. Just play your favorite casino games and rack up entries, but only at Saracen Casino Resort.
Saracen Casino Resort, Vegas, Arkansas style.
Gambling problem? Call 800-GAMBLER.
Are you someone who tries to drive while distracted by your phone? Someone who props it up on the steering wheel or peeks down at it for a glance? Or just scrolls and scrolls? If so, you could be the next person to get into a fender bender, get a ticket, veer off the road, or even cause a crash that kills you or someone else. Enough with the phones already. Put them down and pay attention, or pay the price. You drive, you text, you pay. Paid for by NHTSA.
Mark your calendars for the 20th annual Double B's BBQ, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Tickets on sale soon.
Sports.
Sports. Sports.
We've got that wood.
I got that wood.
And much more than you can handle on 103.7 The Buzz. KABZ Little Rock. Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Arkansas State Senator Frederick Love is suing Pulaski County over his forced resignation from the position of Director of Community Services. In his lawsuit, Love says he was pressured to resign or be fired over a dispute that comes from his firing of the county housing director. He says Judge Barry Hyde told him he did nothing wrong, but it's best that he resign. Love is seeking equitable and injunctive relief, reinstating him to his former position and giving him back pay. The Arkansas Department of Finance and Administration is looking to award $10 million in grants to enhance the state power grid. They're now accepting proposals for the 2024 Grid Enhancement Grant Funding Program. Utilities and related companies can apply for a portion of that $10 million in order to devise methods of strengthening Arkansas's electric grid and prevent power outages. The deadline to apply is July 19th. For more news and weather, download our free KATV News and Weather apps. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
For interior, exterior, commercial, and residential painting, hire the pros at Serta Pro Painters. Get your free estimate at CertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Look for a much cooler day today with highs only in the low 60s. Sunny, though, tonight's low drops down to 41. The mid-60s on Thursday, and by Friday, back up to 70. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Tito's Handmade Vodka presents the 2024 103.7 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Registration is now open. Go to 103.7thebuzz.com to register your four-person team. Prizes will be awarded in both morning and afternoon flights. The 2024 103.7 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka and brought to you in part by Line Legal and Genesis of Conway, with special thanks to Corky's Ribbon Barbecue, Sonic, and Michelob.
What do you do when the power goes out? Well, now you can do anything you want when you purchase a Generac home standby generator from Generator Supercenter of Little Rock. Come visit the experts at Central Arkansas's only generator showroom, located on Chenal Parkway in West Little Rock. We offer a turnkey solution, financing, and 24/7 service. Visit our website for more info at generatorsupercenterofLittleRock.com. The standby power people.
A motorcycle seems pretty simple. It has one engine, two wheels, and plenty of attitude. But you crash one of these babies, and things get complicated quick. That's when you need these guys.
At Rainwater Holton Sexton, we keep it simple. When the insurance company tries to pay you less, we fight to get you more.
No hassle, no confusing legal terms, and no fee unless we get money for you.
Keep it simple. Call Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton. Motorcycle crash? Anywhere in the state, dial 888-8888.
Non-lawyer spokesperson.
Responsible attorneys Michael Rainwater and Bob Sexton.
Clint Sterner here for Low T Center. Fellas, if you've been feeling tired and grumpy, maybe you've noticed a lack of motivation and drive, a little weight gain, loss of muscle mass. These could all be signs of low testosterone levels. It happens. It's not if, it's when. The key, fellas, is that you address the issue. At Low T Center, it's easy to get your levels checked. We're talking a simple blood test with results back in about 25 minutes. Low T Center, it's not your typical doctor's office, no sir. It's concierge medicine for all of us men. They're physicians. They specialize in treating low testosterone with customized treatments for each patient. Most health insurance is accepted for treatment, and they have affordable and convenient treatment options, including physician-monitored self-inject treatments for established patients. Those treatments, they ship directly to your home each and every month, so there's no need to drive to the center for weekly visits. Right now, Low T Center, it's only $25 to get your T levels tested with the results back in 25 minutes. Make your health and quality of life a priority and go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment today. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Clayton Homes of Conway is moving. But until then, you can find them at their location on East Dave Ward Drive, where you're invited to stop by on April 12th and 13th for their inventory reduction sale. Save thousands of dollars on in-stock inventory of homes. Lenders will be available for all your financing questions. There'll be door prizes, food, fun, and entertainment for the whole family. April 12th and 13th at Clayton Homes of Conway.
RJ Hawk here with Chris Roberts from Southern Bank. And Chris, you know, we've talked so much about that hometown feel and what it's like at Southern Bank. But if you're a commercial investor, they need to come talk to you.
We're involved with a lot of customers that have projects across the United States. Those projects can be some of the biggest projects you would see in your communities. So really, there's no project that's too large for us to look at.
If somebody's interested in learning more about what Southern Bank can do for their commercial investments, how do they get in touch with you?
You just pick up the phone and call me at 501-424-0900. Just love to talk to you about your project, see what you've got going on, and see how we can be a help to you.
And you talk about being a help. You really invest into your commercial investors by helping them through the process, looking at things to look out for along the way.
I like to think we can throw things off of each other, listen to different viewpoints, and come to the best decision.
If you want to learn more, go online, bankwithsouthern.com, or call Chris, 424-0900, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Willie D's Rock and Roll Piano Bar, open every Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Cold drinks and dueling pianos. Deep Nightclub downstairs hosts karaoke on Tuesdays and DJ spin on Friday and Saturday nights. Visit WillieD'sPianoBar.com.
From the Eat My Catfish studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Hour number two of Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City.
And now, Trey Biddy is brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai, Arkansas's number one Hyundai dealer, and Genesis of Conway, Arkansas's only Genesis dealer. Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today. Now, here's Trey Biddy.
Good afternoon, Trey.
Hey, guys.
What have you learned new today?
Well, I mean, I'm expecting Eric Musselman to end up at USC. But, you know, I've heard all kinds of things this morning. There was all kinds of talk yesterday that, you know, wheels up at 9 a.m. and all this stuff. Last I'd heard this morning, Musselman was still in Fayetteville. So there's that. I don't know that I think everybody's probably just going to find out at about the same time when it's announced. I'm thinking probably tomorrow. But, yeah, this is obviously, I mean, since yesterday, this looked like definitely the direction we were headed in with Musselman. And, you know, just that one job, that kind of job that, you know, that he was really interested in and getting back on the West Coast. So from what I'd heard as of this morning, and this may have been of, you know, stuff that, that happened yesterday, they were still asking questions about Musselman, wanting to find out about, you know, why this season went the way it did, asking about his relationships with, you know, other coaches and, you know, what kind of, how he works with others, all those kind of questions that you'd ask when you're trying to find out more about a candidate. But they were still asking all of that stuff, I guess, as of yesterday. One source told me Brian Dutcher was actually the top target, but wasn't interested in leaving in San Diego State. And then that's kind of where things turned to Eric Musselman. And the Hunter Yurecek stuff, certainly not out of the AD playbook, but it is interesting the way all that's unfolded. You know, when he was that group that did that interview, One Star Podcast, was they actually reached out to me on March 26th before he'd ever put out the Must Bus video, which, I mean, it almost looks like that video was like, which you're still here, you know, I mean, but definitely not out of the AD playbook, but, you know, it's interesting how that's looked. I've been told for a month and a half that, you know, Chris Beard would definitely be interested in this and highly interested in the Arkansas job. And so we'll see how things play out. But, you know, there was a while we were looking at it and we're like, what if, you know, with all this stuff that's happened, what if he doesn't get the USC job? What if it doesn't play out? Because we were hearing that they were still, you know, asking around and stuff and trying to find out more information about Musselman. So, but it does look like it's going to happen. I mean, from every angle. I mean, every single angle that I've checked on, it just looks like a matter of time, maybe as something as early as tomorrow.
And you're also dealing with the two-hour difference, Trey.
Yeah.
When you say something is happening at noon Central Time, we do have to remember that's 10 o'clock out on the West Coast. So
sure.
That does make a difference. And Jets can make up a lot of time in the air. So anything could still possibly be happening. I'm surprised there haven't been the tracking of airplane numbers and so forth that we've yet to hear about. But who knows? So maybe somebody may be doing that as well.
Yeah. Well, with Hunter, I assume he's on his way to Final Four. I mean, that's where everybody goes, right? That's agents, ADs, coaches. It's like coaching search central type of territory. So I would expect that.
That used to be their convention.
Yeah, I believe so. Yep.
Jake, good afternoon. You have a question or comment for Trey?
Absolutely. Good afternoon, Rick. Good afternoon, Randy.
Hey, Jake.
Good afternoon, Trey. You guys doing all right?
Doing great.
Yes.
Thank you.
All right. So I'm going to bring up something that's been brought up a lot, and I'm just going to say my piece on it, and then a couple questions.
Okay.
Kevin McPherson was completely in the wrong yesterday, the way he talked to you guys. And in my mind at that time, driving my truck, I thought, you know what? You know who would never do that? Is Trey Biddy, because he's a professional. I'd actually like to know what credentials Kevin McPherson has, other than being a keyboard warrior on a freaking message board, which I didn't even know those were a thing anymore. Like, seriously, like, when you quote sources and this and that and whatever, and you know, Trey, you're never like that, man. You're honest. You're upfront. If you know it, you know it. If you don't, you don't. But you let us know. And, yes, I understand that sometimes you hear information that you're not supposed to – you don't want to let out the cat out of the bag, so to speak, until it becomes public. But what McPherson did to you guys yesterday was deplorable. 100%, and you guys did not deserve that. And I'm not the only one in Arkansas that
we do
you
not,
guys listen to the other
We do not, Jake. We do not need defending. Kevin was entitled to his feelings, his thoughts, and how that was perceived or received by others. That is how they receive it. But Rick and I both do not need defending in any form or any fashion. That was strictly Kevin's opinions and feelings.
Hey, Roger that, Randy. I hear you loud and clear, bud. Couple things. Musselman going, you know, if he goes to USC, I really like Eric Musselman, man. I wish he'd stay here, but if his heart's not in it, like, he doesn't realize what a good deal he has here and how endearing the fan base is.
Hold on a minute, Jake. How do we know everything is so hunky-dory with the Arkansas program? And I'm talking whether it be basketball or football, whatever it may be. How do we know that things are this perfect at Arkansas? Because if you go by any, and I've seen so many different opinions, and I say opinions because I don't know how these folks, on the other hand, are getting their information. But as an example, I'm seeing anywhere from 12th to 14th is where Arkansas supposedly ranks in regards to NIL money for basketball. If that's the case, if that is the true case, to me, that's not perfect. That's not a hunky-dory situation for the coach.
Randy, it's not perfect anywhere. It is not perfect anywhere. It is not perfect anywhere. And you can search for the perfect job and get there and find out there are things you don't like about that. That's just the way it is.
You ask any coach, they need more NIL money.
Yeah,
no matter what they're making.
Let me finish real quick, guys. I think Hunter Yurecek, I still think he's a great AD. You remember how everyone was high on him when we hired him and then the hires that he made and stuff? I think he's still the same guy. I think he's got a plan in his back pocket, and I believe in him. I don't want him going anywhere. And, Trey, real quick, I always ask this, man, but I'm going to ask you again this week. Talk to me about the secondary. Talk to me about safeties and cornerbacks. I'll let you guys go. Love the show. Love you guys.
Thank you, Jake.
Yeah, well, I felt like kind of a kid walking into the middle of a movie. I had no idea exactly what was going on with all the other stuff. But anyway, every coach in the country is going to want more NIL money. No situation, as Rick said, is perfect. You know, I think Eric Musselman is a guy that lives on edge. He's probably not the easiest to work for. I know he's very demanding, you know, and so, you know, there's a lot of things that come with being a coach. We talked about it before. You have to be a little crazy to be a basketball coach, to be a successful one, to be a football coach, too. You just have to be a little insane. You just do to have success. So, you know, Musselman, we always knew eventually would go somewhere else. When I was talking about the other jobs that he was being mentioned for, there was people that were saying he's been offered the SMU job, and, you know, he was in Chicago to talk to DePaul when he hadn't been to Chicago in like 20 years. I mean, the Louisville job, all that stuff, none of that stuff was really viable. But when this one opened up, that's what we've said for years. You know, Musselman's not going to be here forever. And if the right situation opens up, the dominoes fall a certain way and there's a West Coast job that he's intrigued with, then, you know, there's definitely a good chance that he will try to get it. And that's what's happened here. Hunter Yurecek's either going to look like he's lost his marbles or he's going to look like he was just posturing and getting out in front of it. And it's all going to depend basically on who comes in to replace Musselman. And that's how we'll feel about Hunter Yurecek. I don't blame Hunter for, you know, people get onto ADs and stuff for extensions they give coaches. And it's just part of the game. Like, football coaches just get extended like every 2 years. It's just part of it. I don't know why it's like that, but it's just all across the country. You get extended and you get a raise or you get fired. And that's just a blanket policy. And we're talking about big numbers. But the thing is, everybody else is doing it in college sports. It's not, you know, not something everybody agrees with, obviously. But when a coach is out of school for a couple years and they're not getting fired, they get raised and extended. Just the way it is, especially in football. Basketball may be a little bit different schedule. But especially in football. So it's hard to, you know, people bring that up a lot with Hunter Yurecek. As far as secondary, I think the secondary should be about as good as it was last year. You know, they lost Nudie McLaughlin. They lost Al Walcott, who was banged up quite a bit last year, but was a pretty significant contributor for them. But basically everybody else is back who was a major player for them in the secondary. Plus, you'd like to think that Jalen Braxton is going to be better, being a year older. Jaheim Singletary, there's been a lot of good talk about him. I think Marquise Robinson has done some good things, the transfer from South Alabama. And Danico Slaughter got a lot of first-team reps at nickel, even with Snacks Johnson being kind of the staple guy there. Those guys kind of rotated back and forth. I could see Slaughter being a guy that works a lot of different positions for him, you know, kind of in maybe that rotation like they kind of started doing last year with Hudson Clark, a guy that comes in, you know, some at safety, comes in some at nickel. And but they still probably ought to look at adding one more safety. And Selman Bridges also is a cornerback, freshman cornerback, has got a lot of potential as well. So overall, you know, if the pass rush is there, defensive line could use a little bit, could use a couple more defensive tackle, but I think they're going to be okay on the edge and getting a good pass rush. So if that's there, then I would think the secondary should be about as good as it was last year or better. You know, you look at Marcus Woodson, defensive passing game coordinator, when he took over at Florida State, and obviously, you know, they may have access to higher caliber of talent, but, you know, they improved pretty dramatically every single year that he was there, and they were really bad, like almost as bad as Arkansas was in 2022 when he took over that position back in, 2019, I believe. So, I would think that they have a chance to be about as good, but might need to add one more safety out of the portal.
Let's talk with Savage. Savage, good afternoon. You got a question or comment for Trey?
Yes, sir. You're doing all right?
What's up, buddy?
Oh, doing good. You know, Trey, last year our football team was terrible. And most of the fan base, most of us callers that call in, everybody knew the season was terrible. And then they hired one man, and everybody forgot about last season. So The soap opera, which is the Arkansas Razorbacks, tomorrow, the day after, whenever this works out, they're going to hire somebody, and everybody's going to ooh and ah over it. So we just got to wait. And, Trey, sometimes not having information, we're not entitled as Razorback fans. We're not supposed to know everything. Last time I checked, I don't have Musselman's phone number. I don't have your check. Their information is their information. We all want it as a microwave society, but we're not supposed to get everything. So as fans, we get upset. Trey, what do your sources tell you? We talk about sources. What do your sources tell you about Musselman's lifestyle? Where is he unhappy? Randy just said it. None of us know if he's unhappy or not. We don't know if it's all rainbows and up there at the basketball program. Nobody knows that, if he's happy or not.
Yeah, I mean, I hear things about, like, you know, riffs and, you know, hard to work for and stuff. We've all heard that kind of stuff. We've seen assistant coaches come and go here. And that's, again, sometimes a product of living on edge like he does. I'm not sure Eric Musselman knows his way around Springdale. You know, the guy gets up early, hits the gym, and he's in the office. I mean, that's – basketball is his life. I really – probably doesn't know his way around certain areas of Northwest Arkansas. You know, his family is obviously very involved, you know, I mean, and you think about, you know, he's got a daughter here who's basically her whole life, you know, she's in junior high, has been Northwest Arkansas.
Yeah.
You know, this is her home, probably is a place that she'll, you know, always remember. Danielle has been very involved in the community also. But again, I'm not sure Musselman really knows his way around town. I would be surprised, just given the nature of who Eric Musselman is. So,
good luck finding his way around L.A.
Yeah, well, I'm
if you
sure
can't find your way around Fayetteville,
like he probably knows that like the back of his hand.
Maybe so.
Yeah. And Rick, the Braves will see the Orioles in the World Series, buddy. We'll see you later.
If that's the World Series, I'd be a happy guy. It'd be great.
Let's talk with Charlie. Charlie, good afternoon. You got a question or comment for Trey?
How you guys doing?
Hey, Charlie.
Eric Musselman. One thing for me, like, you know, there are some people that are all around. And, you know, look, the 8 tournament games, right, since he's been here, because it got canceled, right? So, success here. Great job.
You're breaking up. But I think I know what he's saying. Right, and I think he's right if he's saying
I'm
what
I'm going to put you on hold, Johnny. You're breaking up.
You know, Musselman came here, and we talked about this a little bit yesterday, but in the, you know, 25 years since Nolan Richardson's been here, there has not been a better basketball coach at Arkansas.
That's right. For results, that's right.
And the facilities, for the most part, have been there. They didn't have the indoor practice facility, which is excellent. But, you know, they got that when Mike Anderson was here. But Mike Anderson, John Pelfrey, Stan Heath, none of those guys were able to do what Musselman did. And, you know, Mike Anderson came the closest. He had a couple of good years, but never felt like they were maybe a threat. Maybe some of the things they were doing in the offseason, okay, this class that they're putting together, you know. So there, it wasn't just the season. And, you know, last year was disappointing. This past season was even more disappointing. But last year they also picked it up, put it together, and made a run in the tournament. Recruiting and stuff is fun. You know, the caller before talked about message boards and stuff. Like, we've got a great community, message board community on our site. And we follow recruiting. We follow the off season. I mean, like it's the regular season. And, you know, winning recruiting battles, getting guys like Anthony Black and Nick Smith and some of the Jordan Walsh, getting some of those big-time recruits that they were able to bring in and, you know, doing the work in the transfer portal and stuff, that's exciting for us. That's fun. And I tell my guys on our staff, you know, if they're getting stressed out about coaching searches or, you know, answering questions and stuff, enjoy it. It's just part of the offseason. It's part of the sport these days. Eric Musselman came here and did a great job. Arkansas won. Arkansas was a good job before he got here. And when now people see what he was able to do here, Arkansas is a great job. It's got great fan support. The fans will come and show up. Even if you're dealing with 20 years of disappointment, they still will show up for you. And I think the NIL situation will be in great order when the change does happen, because I think the powers that be, the people with the pockets, will recognize what needs to be done to bring in a great basketball coach at Arkansas. And I think it'll all be done. And so, and we'll see what plays out. I mean, there's a chance that everybody gets played and all that stuff, and it's a roller coaster after all this gets done. But this is where Hunter Yurecek gets to show a lot of people what that he knows what he's doing. And I enjoy it. I mean, it's crazy. It keeps me up at night sometimes. But, I mean, this is the business I chose, so why would I sit around and mope when things like this happen? It's just better to embrace it and dive in. And I've covered a lot of coaching searches in my day. And, you know, I think the most important thing is just to have fun with it.
And
try to be accurate and have fun.
That's right. Try and be accurate. Know that, just as our Savage said, we're not going to know everything, and that's okay. It is okay not to know everything.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, this will give us a moment to catch up a little bit on our live fan feedback. Let's see. Guys, this from Luke. Guys, the Arkansas fan base is being roasted to a crisp by the national media. Heard many top analysts call Arkansas fans entitled and fools what they're calling for mistreatment of Musselman.
Oh my gosh.
We don't care.
That's right. Who cares what that? You're right. Thank you, Trey. Who cares what anybody thinks and what
we're going to care
what
somebody who has never stepped foot in this state, who has no ties or connections to this state, where they think we should be, what they think we are capable of. We don't care.
That's right. Good for you.
And this one ties in with Ryan says, guys, I'm not sure if you're aware, but we're being destroyed by the national media. Jim Rome said he and Musk have been lifelong friends, spent 3 hours pounding Hog fans. Sad times, guys.
I tell you, I really care what Jim Rome thinks. I really care what Jim Rome thinks.
Musselman and Rome have a good relationship. They're both from the same region. But there'll be another story for him tomorrow.
All right, Trey, we will talk with you tomorrow.
Bye, guys.
Trey Beatty, HogSports.com, being brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai and Genesis of Conway. Drive Time Sports will continue in a moment.
Crawfish season is finally back at Eat My Catfish. We've got fresh, live crawfish, and all you have to do is just add the fixins. Be sure to come see us or order online at eatmycatfish.com. Eat local, eat fresh, eat my catfish.
You can hear the best of the NCAA tournament on 106.7 Buzz 2, from the very beginning all the way to the championship game. March Madness on 103.7 The Buzz and 106.7 Buzz 2.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more. At the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream. A cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at Walmart Supercenters and neighborhood markets.
Hello, folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
Tackle your outdoor projects with Greenway Equipment's Lawn Patrol Package. Handling is effortless with the John Deere 1023E's twin touch foot controls with a hydrostatic transmission and four-wheel drive with power steering. The 60D Drive Over Auto Connect Belly Mower makes mowing easy. And the 120R Quick Park Loader is perfect for dirt moving and mulching projects. With 0% APR for 84 months and a 6-year powertrain warranty, it's a deal you can't miss. For more information, head to your local Greenway or visit gogreenway.com. With approved credit, see dealer for details.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, you feed your crave for sports by listening to Drive Time Sports. Much like you feed your crave at any of the 7 Eat My Catfish locations. You're safe at home with Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. Thanks for being with us today. In a moment, we'll be joined by Bart Reap, Pure Sweat Basketball Skills. But got to talk to you about the Riverfront Steakhouse with that fantastic deal. The chef special for $60. That's dinner for two for $60. And it all starts with the premiere salad bar anywhere, period. That is the Riverfront Salad Bar for Two, which is the largest salad bar in North America. And it just, the good times just continue from there, because you get to select two side items, whether it's the hibachi fries, fried rice with chicken, the baked potato, onion rings, mashed potatoes, spinach supreme, french fries, zucchini, wild mushrooms, fresh wild mushrooms, I must say. But then you get to the big one, the entree. That is the filet, the 10-ounce filet cooked to your perfection. That's right, cooked the way you want it. And then, in combination with that, you're going to get four of the Frank Fletcher, the double F, fried shrimp. And these are not small, folks. These are, they're a handful. I'll just simply say that. All for $60. That's what's fantastic. All for $60. And where do you find it? At the Riverfront Steakhouse in North Little Rock. Now, realizing there's always something going on at Simmons Arena, at least it seems like, you may want to make a reservation. I would highly encourage a reservation. 371-9000, 371-9000. Ask for Shapur. Tell him I sent you. Make your reservation. Riverfront Steakhouse in North Little Rock at the Wyndham Hotel, and ask for the dinner for two for $60.
It's time for the basket.
Whoa. We got to get a new one cut, because today we have a new sponsor for the one and only.
We do.
The one and only Bart Reed. Pure Sweat Basketball, yes, Skills. That is Birch Tree Communities. Wow. Great. A brand new sponsor.
Brand new sponsor. Now, we still have Martin Orthopedics.
That's correct.
No better business than orthopedics and knees and taking care of athletes and fans and parents. But we expand with Birch Tree, who is, you know, Randy, my mom has been a therapist and a social worker for 30-plus years. So Birch Tree is something that's close to my family's heart and mental health profession. And so Birch Tree has branches all over the place doing great things. So could not be more proud to represent them and looking forward to some good time with their sponsorship and backing.
And with that being said, what is going on in the basketball world?
Well, listen, as the world turns, this is certainly exciting times. And this is where we like to see the Final Four. Randy, I don't know if you agree, but I think Arkansas now becomes, potentially, if Coach Musselman leaves, the biggest job in the stratosphere right now in terms of trying to be filled. So there's no better opportunity from a fan's perspective. There's more moving and shaking going on at the Final Four than any other time. So it's a good time to be looking for coaches. Obviously, I think Arkansas is a fantastic job, pays a lot of money. SEC is a premium league, so I don't think there's any probably lack of willing suitors to throw their name in the hat for that particular job if Coach Musselman does, in fact, decide to leave.
I think that's the key phrase. If he decides to leave, we're not sure exactly what all is going on there, but we do believe he is going to be sometime very soon, if not, if he's even there now. That would be what...
Yeah, it's 3:35 there, so he's probably there.
Probably good chance he's there by now. Let's talk to Dan. Sorry. Dan, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Good afternoon. How are you?
Doing great. How about you, Dan?
Hey, Dan.
I'm doing pretty good. A couple of thoughts. Well, a question first. I just tuned in to you guys, and I think I just heard Musselman has not made a decision yet.
Well, we don't know that. Most of us who have done this for a long time see it as he already had the job when he went out there. You don't leave Arkansas to go to USC to interview. Like, oh, are you one of three guys? You just don't do that. So that's what we think, but we don't know.
Okay. Well, an observation. Number one, I think he should be congratulated for the winning seasons that he's had up there, because it's been exceptional. But I'm going to predict something. Number one, the guy is ill-tempered, He's shown disrespect for referees. He's shown disrespect for fans. He's shown disrespect for people in the bleachers watching the games. And that's really irritated me the whole time he's been up there. It sounds like that he's a very strict disciplinarian when he deals with the players. And I think he has got to take responsibility for this losing season. He gets responsibility when he wins. He's got to accept responsibility for when he loses. And with the kind of money that's on the table right now for coaches and players, I think you win or you walk. And I think there's going to be more of that. I also predict that if he is as strong-willed as he is as a coach, that those kinds of coaches, not unlike people like Nick Saban, are going to become fewer and fewer because the money is going to move the game and the game's going to be run by the players. And the coaches are going to have to figure out how to fit into that because the nature of collegiate athletics has completely changed. That's just a thought, just an observation. I hope the guy stays. He's certainly not perfect, but I do believe that his style of coaching may be on the wane, honestly.
All right, Dan, thank you.
I don't know. Bart can address that. I think players still play for coaches. I don't think any player, even in the NBA where they're making enormous amounts of money, I don't think they tell the coach what to do. I think the coach still has a handle on everything. Now, whether he must rubs people wrong or not, that's not for us to determine. It's for them. But I think you're always going to have coaches who say this is the way it's done, and if you don't do it that way, you don't need to be here.
Yeah, and I think it kind of speaks to Coach Muss's not personality in a bad way, but, you know, guys, this is kind of where we see him explore opportunities. And he's done nothing this year. From talking to Coach Muss in the past, I think he's done in the previous years. He's been his own agent. He's looked, I believe, since after really year two, he's looked for opportunities. Doesn't mean he's looking to leave, but he's exploring opportunities. I think this is the first time, guys, and I think we were all on the same page here. I only saw him going for a West Coast job or something back in the NBA. I just never saw the Midwest or Louisville, or I just never saw that as being a great fit. Certainly Arkansas is a premium job, and players still do go for coaches. But we're finding out coaches are really graded on four games in March. As much as Coach Musselman has won, when he did not win those couple of games in March that he has won in the past, it's a big blow, especially when you don't even get there. So he's a highly emotional guy that comes with good and bad, but certainly Coach Musselman is an excellent basketball coach and will be hard to replace.
All right, Bart, let's play the what if or if you know anything at this point. And that is there are two players that signed with Arkansas coming out of high school, and then you have four players who are still part of the roster. Do we know any status updates, or do you think those players, and that would be a total of six, do you think those six players right now are in limbo waiting to see what happens, or do you know if anything has already happened with any of those six players?
Nope, they're in limbo. They're going to be in hard limbo until one decision is made or the other. And even if Coach Musselman leaves, they will still be in limbo until someone is hired, which it should be, Rick, I don't know if you agree, relatively quickly because of recruiting.
Absolutely.
And they will evaluate that coach stepping in, and they will pay them the courtesy of evaluating that, even if it's someone that they're unfamiliar with, because, again, they've already gone through the process. So. But that's top priority. A new coach does not want to rebuild a roster and have to sign 10 new players. I can promise you that.
And how about Leighton Blocker? Could he be won back by a different coach?
Yes, absolutely. He absolutely can. I think any Arkansas player that leaves, especially when there's a coaching change, this is where he home. This is where he wants to be. If you're looking at a Porter Mosier or someone, I could easily see Leighton staying at Arkansas. Depending on who the coach is and the style of play.
What about Joe's opinion? I know there was an announcement today by Arkansas State. I don't know if he actually signed paperwork or not. I assume even when you're talking someone out of the transfer portal, you can't make that kind of announcement until it is actually a player signed. Is that correct?
That's my understanding, Randy. But do they have, Rick, and this is probably up, is there an out clause on that where if you sign that there's a certain amount of days or period? Because it has to be. I would think anyone, especially someone like Joseph, that would be very style specific, would be willing to look at whoever comes in for a coach. It could be potentially a good fit. But again, if he's already signed, so it doesn't matter.
Unless they stayed elected to release him from that letter.
Right. But it's so fluid right now, guys, and that's really all this stuff speculate. But all these people are anxiously waiting for a coach to be put in place, and this is not uncommon. This is stuff that happens all the time. So recruits are well-versed in the process, even if it's their first time. They know, and I think they feel like Arkansas will get a quality coach.
All right, let's talk with Brian. Brian, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports. In fact, let me just go ahead and put you on hold, Brian, because I just now looked at the clock. We're about 20 seconds away from taking our break. So, we've got a lot to touch on, and you may want to mull this one, Bart, while we're in the break. Hopeful Hawk says, Bart, any chance Honor Boateng flips from Missouri if Muss is out of the picture? So you may want to think about that one when we come back. All right, Rick Schaefer, Bart Reed, Pure Sweat Basketball Skills, thanks to Birch Street Community. I'm Randy Rainwater. Drive Time Sports will continue in a moment.
Listen every Wednesday when R.J. Hawk joins his old buddies on Morning Mayhem. Presented by Natural State Wholesale Flooring. See everything that Natural State Wholesale has to offer at naturalstatewholesale.com.
Heart Royal Flush Tour 2024. Saturday, October 12th, Simmons Bank Arena. A journey through the hits and timeless classics. The iconic band returns with special guest Cheap Trick. Tickets on sale Friday at 10 a.m. at heart-music.com. Don't miss two Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductees. Heart with Cheap Trick live.
Time is running out to take advantage of the $50 rebates on the Stoger STR9 9mm performance-grade personal defense handguns at Max Prairie Wings in Stuttgart. Like the Stoger STR9 9mm automatic, starting at $249 after mail-in rebate. But this offer expires April 30th, so hurry before time runs out. Max Prairie Wings in Stuttgart, with the best selection, the most competitive prices, and all the ammo you need. So make the short drive to Stuttgart today, or check them out online at maxpw.com.
Clint Sterner here for Low T Center. Fellas, if you've been feeling tired and grumpy, maybe you've noticed a lack of motivation and drive, a little weight gain, loss of muscle mass, these could all be signs of low testosterone levels. It happens. It's not if, it's when. The key, fellas, is that you address the issue. At Low T Center, it's easy to get your levels checked. We're talking a simple blood test with results back in about 25 minutes. Low T Center, it's not your typical doctor's office, no sir. It's concierge medicine for all of us men. They're physicians. They specialize in treating low testosterone with customized treatments for each patient. Most health insurance is accepted for treatment, and they have affordable and convenient treatment options, including physician-monitored self-inject treatments for established patients. Those treatments, they ship directly to your home each and every month, so there's no need to drive to the center for weekly visits. Right now, Low T Center, it's only $25 to get your T levels tested with the results back in 25 minutes. Make your health and quality of life a priority and go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment today. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Johnston's Home Center in Benton is your one-stop shop for appliances, bedding, lawn care, and sewing. Speaking of appliances, Johnston's Home Center has a wide selection of home appliances for cooking, cleanup, laundry, and refrigeration. Johnston's also has mattresses, so you can get a good night's sleep, plus a wide selection of vacuums to keep your home classy and clean. Johnston's Home Center, 1421 Military Road in Benton, or on the web at johnstonshomecenter.com. If they don't have it, you probably don't need it.
Only Saracen Casino gives away a brand new car every month. And not just any cars, but the hottest cars on the road. Like for April, a Porsche 718 Boxster from Gossett Porsche in Memphis. You need to be driving a super cool Porsche Roadster, and you can. It's easy. Just play your favorite casino games and rack up entries, but only at Saracen Casino Resort.
Saracen Casino Resort, Vegas, Arkansas style.
Gambling problem? Call 800-GAMBLER.
Now, back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish studios. Eat fresh, eat local, eat my catfish. You're in hog heaven. This is Drive Time Sports, a presentation of the Buzz Radio Network.
Drive Time Sports in the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. We will be rejoined by Bart here in a few moments. Double B's, where you always gas it, grab it, and go, continues to have the great specials, even though we have now moved into a new month. Gosh, hard to believe we're already the third day of April. But these are great specials. You may want to load up for this weekend with all of the sports that we'll want to watch and tune into. You got to have all the proper snacks and drinks. It all begins with the Frito-Lay products, such as two for $4 on the Lay's products. And then you've got the drink specials. And I got one the other day. Put it in the fridge, because I think it's only right, put it in the fridge. I love 7-Up to begin with. Now I like it even better out of the glass bottle. 12-ounce 7-Up glass bottles, two for $3. That's right, two for $3. And the 16-ounce Red Bull, two for $8. And the 16-ounce Rockstar, two for $5. And this is the softball, I'll call it the softball, baseball, whatever you want to call it. I'll call this the weekend warriors, or even the weekday warriors, the high schoolers. The 28-ounce Gatorade, two for $5. Kids love Gatorade. Where do you find all this good stuff? You find it at Double B's. It's where you gas it, you grab it, and you go. Make it Double B's. Joined again by Bart Reed, Pure Sweat Basketball Skills. And Bart, honor Boateng.
Yes, sir.
Do you think Arkansas might have a chance at honor? That is, if there is a new coach at Arkansas.
Well, I think anytime there's a change, and Arkansas was in the final two, you have to keep an eye out for that. But I will say this, and I can only speak to my kids' decision. It's more about what is that fits honor versus what Arkansas's not doing. So I think when you get a coaching change, it doesn't automatically mean an Arkansas kid will go back to Arkansas, but it certainly does open up an opportunity for honor, because I do know one of his big criteria was kind of offensive style of play. But I think probably what could affect the Missouri decision more than anything, Randy, is you're seeing so much volatility, is Mizzou went 8-24 this year. So they had a not great year, and certainly Coach Gates, I feel like, is doing a great job. But we seem to be in a very low-tolerance culture for not winning basketball games. So that could come into factor. If they have a young team next year, it's certainly something to keep its eye on, but I don't think it'll affect honor transitioning into Missouri. Could take effect maybe if after he's there for a year or two, maybe.
All right, now let's talk to Brian. Brian, my apology, ran you right into the break. Good afternoon.
Oh, that's all right. Good. How are y'all doing, Randy?
Good, Brian.
So, I got a personal comment and kind of a question. My comment would be, Musselman has really kind of showed no loyalty to Arkansas by taking this interview. So if I was Arkansas, I'd just go ahead and start bringing coaches in to interview us, just for no other reason to make a statement like, hey, you ain't interested in us, we're not interested in you, later.
Well, let's say this. Again, Arkansas is not going to bring in coaches for interviews. If Musselman leaves, the first time you will see the new coach on campus will be when he's introduced.
Yep.
That's the way most schools do it, is they don't do it. They don't do interviews on campus.
Especially Power 5 coaches.
Right, yeah.
So my question is, and I heard this on another radio station, was this all started over Ron Holland. And the simple fact was Musselman wanted more NIL money to get Ron Holland, and the two guys that run NIL wouldn't give it to him, so Ron Holland went to G League. Is there any truth on that? No, I ain't got to listen.
I have heard that thrown out there.
I don't know.
I don't know how valid it is. I know that the money that the G League, on the other hand, threw at Ron Holland was big-time dollars.
It was a lot.
And I don't know that...
I don't know if anybody could compete.
Yeah, I start to say, I don't know that any other school could have matched that. I'm talking about at the collegiate level. And it took... It just simply was a dollar situation. We've heard that about some other players, that it basically got down to a bidding war. I mean, Arkansas made, I thought, a very fair offer, from what I understand, to Hunter Dickinson, who left Michigan, ended up at Kansas. It all ended up being dollars and cents. So you can't just keep unloading. You can't put all your money into one basket. And sometimes the asking price just gets greater than what you have the resources available. Because you can't just put it into one player.
That's right. And just so everyone knows, from a basketball standpoint, Arkansas is seen from the surrounding SEC schools to be way ahead in terms of NIL offering to players. So, in fact, it's kept some coaches, I think, out of recruiting in the state. So, I don't think Arkansas basketball, I know coaches always want more, they're not second fiddle to anyone in terms of offering NIL on the basketball front, or at least the perception is not. The perception is that we're leading that particular category, or one of the leaders anyway.
Yeah, now my understanding, and you may know a different story on this one, when it got down to Alabama in Arkansas for Grant Nelson, NIL won out again there.
It absolutely did. But let's say this, Randy. I think he was leaning towards Alabama. I think Arkansas's competitive bid brought it back where it was at least in play.
Right.
From what I remember, because he was leaning Bama. So, but certainly a quality player.
But Arkansas, yeah, but sure. Bama was also there. Determined. I was told they were going to get Grant Nelson.
Yes.
They felt like he might have been the missing piece. And it looks like he's done a pretty good job for him. Let's talk to Justin.
Yes, sir.
Never mind. Okay. This from Polar Vortex. He says, to Elite Eights and Sweet 16 will be hard to duplicate for any new coach. He's probably gone. I will miss him. However, I don't think we can call him a disciplinarian. Most coaches before NIL would have set Devo Davis out for a game after quitting on his teammates twice. So, let's see. We've read that one. David says...
The distractions took its toll.
Do what? I'm sorry, Bart.
That's for sure. The distractions took its toll this year. I think when you look at it, it was a different Coach Musselman. It was a different team. So the Devo type of situation, and I'm not saying it was just Devo, it took its toll on this year's basketball team. That is for sure. Because the talent level is still what beat Purdue in the exhibition game, and you see Purdue has a chance to win a national championship. I think a lot of the off-court stuff really dictated a lot of the success, that and that we could not guard anyone effectively for longer than a couple of minutes. That had a huge factor in it, too.
Okay, this one real quick from Bill. What does Bart think about the ladies' Final Four, in particular Iowa?
How good is Caitlin Clark? Wow. She's as exciting to watch as any player. And I mean, Steph Curry, when he was in his prime.
I like Juju Watkins, though.
I do too. You know, you have to be – the physicality at that level is just amazing. I love South Carolina. I love their size. A lot of this stuff is going to come down to, and you see it, a lot of these teams like UConn, they struggle to shoot the basketball. Shooting is still the primo skill to have. If you're going to beat Iowa, you're going to have to make some three-point shots because in a couple of those games, Randy, this weekend, they're just really fighting for inside the lane, and it's everything so congested. I think that's why Iowa's so different.
You like Iowa?
I do.
All right.
Do you?
There's your national champion. Right now I'm going with Connecticut because of their grit.
There you go.
And I sure like that Bukers. She's a player, too. All right, Bart.
She's a player.
That is Bart Reed, Pure Sweat Basketball Skills, thanks to Birch Tree Communities.
Birch Tree Communities, providing care for individuals living with severe mental illness in their own supervised home environment. Their staff serves as a guide to members on their journey to independence in the community. If you have a client, friend, or loved one diagnosed with schizophrenia, schizoaffective or bipolar disorder, and are in need of assisted residential care, please contact Birch Tree Communities Admissions Department or online at birchtree.org. Birch Tree Communities, a place called home.
It's Justin Akers from my good friends at Serta Pro Painters. And right here in Central Arkansas, you can get exactly what you need from a painting standpoint, and you can get it from the folks you trust and believe in. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. And it comes with free estimates. You get great communication along the way and professional painting. There are certain things you should attempt on your own. In my opinion, painting is not one of them. Turn it over to the right folks at the right price. It's Serta Pro Painters. Online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
Slim Chickens of Central Arkansas presents Rolling with Nolan on Drive Time Sports with Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer every Thursday at 6 on 103.7 The Buzz.
We are just a bunch of guys having fun. Just one has exceptional hair. Nothing more, nothing less. 103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Arkansas State Senator Frederick Love is suing Pulaski County over his forced resignation from the position of Director of Community Services. In his lawsuit, Love says he was pressured to resign or be fired over a dispute that comes from his firing of the county housing director. He says Judge Barry Hyde told him he did nothing wrong, but it's best that he resign. Love is seeking equitable and injunctive relief, reinstating him to his former position and giving him back pay. The Arkansas Department of Finance and Administration is looking to award $10 million in grants to enhance the state power grid. They're now accepting proposals for the 2024 Grid Enhancement Grant Funding Program. Utilities and related companies can apply for a portion of that $10 million in order to devise methods of strengthening Arkansas's electric grid and prevent power outages. The deadline to apply is July 19th. For more news and weather, download our free KATV News and Weather apps. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Look for a much cooler day today with highs only in the low 60s. Sunny, though, tonight's low drops down to 41. Mid-60s on Thursday, and by Friday, back up to 70. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Tito's Handmade Vodka presents the 2024 103.7 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Registration is now open. Go to 103.7thebuzz.com to register your four-person team. Prizes will be awarded in both morning and afternoon flights. The 2024 103.7 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka and brought to you in part by Line Legal and Genesis of Conway, with special thanks to Corky's Ribbon Barbecue, Sonic, and Michelob.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more. At the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
Try Slim Chicken's new Memphis-style barbecue chicken sandwich for a limited time only. Slim's 100% all-natural hand-breaded chicken breast, shaken in tangy barbecue sauce, layered with fresh, crisp pickles, and that house-made creamy coleslaw, all on a toasted brioche bun. The Memphis-style barbecue chicken sandwich at Slim Chicken's for a limited time only. That's tasty.
This is the Pigskin Preacher bringing you the word. The psalmist writes, "The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hands. Day after day they pour forth speech. Night after night they reveal knowledge. There is no speech or language where their voice is not heard." You'll see this for yourself on April the 8th, 2024, as Arkansas is right in the path to see the solar eclipse. See it safely by picking up officially licensed eclipse glasses at Doubleby's. Only $5 for one pair or $20 for five. Every one of Doubleby's 34 locations across Arkansas will carry these glasses. Doubleby's is your one-stop eclipse shop because Doubleby's is where you gas it, grab it, watch the eclipse, and go. That's Doubleby's.
For Pulaski County residents and businesses, do recycling right by recycling old electronic equipment. How? Come to North Little Rock Simmons Bank Arena parking lot on Tuesday, April 2nd or Wednesday, April 3rd for an electronic recycling event. Learn more at recyclingunplugged.com. If it's electronic and no longer usable, drop it off and we'll recycle it for free. For information, go to recyclingunplugged.com.
There are no ordinary days in Arkansas. Hike to inspiring summits, bike on world-class trails, or fish in sparkling waters. Or see some of the world's top art collections and explore historic sites dedicated to everything from civil rights to rock and roll. After that, eat some award-winning barbecue and sip a local craft beer. So go on, get out there, and explore what the natural state has to offer. Find out more at arkansas.com.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile. And the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time. There's Grainger, offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. Go ahead, feel your engine. Admire that perfectly installed exhaust. Your vehicle's moving along this freeway like it was made from fresh installs and a whole lot of love. With eBay Motors, you get over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only, exclusions apply.
Live from the Eat My Catfish Studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Hour number three of Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer. Standing by in Northwest Arkansas, I'm Randy Rainwater from the capital city.
It's time for Rollin' with Nolan on Drive Time Sports with Coach Nolan Richardson. Brought to you by Slim Chickens. There's lots of places to get chicken, but there's only one Slim's, serving Central Arkansas and now open in Cabot and Jacksonville.
Good afternoon, Coach.
Good afternoon.
Well, Coach, there's a lot going on around the Arkansas basketball program. Yeah, I don't know if you get on social media or any of that stuff, but evidently Eric Musselman's interviewing for another job today. Any thoughts on that?
I have no clue what's going on. Well, I live out in the country. I hardly ever use the telephone and don't know what the radio looks like sometimes. So sometimes when I hear things, I say, oh, that happened? Yeah, it did. Okay. But I don't – you there was a call that told me that he might be out in California.
Yeah, at USC.
USC. Yeah. I guess I know about as much as you guys know.
Well, you were
and I don't know what you know.
Well, we don't know what we know either, so we're all in the same boat. So it was a different time when you were there, but I'm just curious. You've told us before that you did talk to the Atlanta Hawks at one point. We are aware of the fact that after your team went to the Final Four in 1990, Ohio State was interested in you. Did you ever talk to them, or how did that play out?
Well, I did. I think in most cases, especially in those days, you owed yourself an opportunity to listen to someone who is wanting to use your service. And of course, that was the days before you had really a true agent that did all your speaking for you.
Right.
And so I was able to visit with them. I get permission from the athletic director, which was Coach Morales, to be able to sit down and visit with. So I had a chance to visit with more than just one. Ohio State, Miami, University of Miami, Washington. And I did a couple of them while I was at the final, at a Final Four. Hmm. And so, however, what I wanted was so high. What I had was what I wanted, and that was the University of Arkansas. So it really was a matter of just listening to what they have to say and judging from what they're trying to give you compared to what another school can give you financially and for facility-wise. All those things come into play, and so it didn't surprise me a coach would take a look, because I believe basically you owe it to yourself and your family.
That's interesting. Do you think back then, man, maybe it's the way that this way today, because all the coaches get together at the Final Four. Is there more of that goes on than we would ever know?
Oh, definitely. I mean, Final Fours are every coach in America, basically, who's a member of the basketball club. You know, that there's where it's kind of like a job search. There's all kinds of jobs available, and they're all there at the Final Four. And so it would be easy for a person that's being considered or want to be a coach, or even go and ask if there's an availability to coach at that particular school. You got everybody right there at the Final Four, so you can pick and choose and find out where they are and go visit with the athletic directors there, presidents are basically there a lot of the times, but most cases it's your ADs that are looking for coaches during the Final Four.
About that. Well, what else goes on there? Do you all have meetings? Are there discussions about rules, or what do you meet about?
There's a clinic. There's usually a clinic in basketball. If you want to go and go to a clinic where there's a coach that's maybe speaking on defense, offense. There's guys that are speaking on fans and how to attract more fans. It's a convention, and there's some mandatory ones that basically they don't make anything mandatory, but they make them all easy accessible so you can get to some of the meetings that they have. Rules committee. They talk to the coaches about whether or not, you want a three-point line or you want the 45-second or 30-second clock. I remember those. I mean, there's so many things going on at the Final Four, more than just the basketball game.
Do the coaches get tickets to the Final Four?
Yes. You have two tickets to the Final Four if you're not in it.
Yeah.
You got more if you're in it. but I believe two or four, maybe four tickets to the event. So you have to be an NABC member.
Yeah.
And so that allows you to purchase two extra ones, and then the guys that are the assistant coach, I mean, days have changed. They get an opportunity to buy a few tickets to be able to attend the Final Four games.
So when your team wasn't in it, did you go to the games? Did you enjoy watching other teams at the Final Four?
Of course. I went to quite a few of the games. Some of them I didn't. But most of the time I went to a game. And it's hard sometimes when you want to go to a basketball game when you want to be there yourself landing it.
Yeah.
But I think that's the driving force for a lot of us, that we go and hope one day that, you know, Final Four is a big deal. I mean,
yeah.
You can't, you know, it's just very hard to get there. You know, once you get there, you basically arrive to the top of the mountain. And a lot of us never get there. And so if you go to enough of them, you just want to be a part of that Final Four mixture. It's a different animal, totally, all together. It's totally different than all the rest of the other tournaments.
Well, you say it's hard to get there. Look at this year's field. Connecticut's a defending champion, so you get that. The other three teams, it is Purdue's last time was 1980, North Carolina State's was 1983, and Alabama's was never. So you got three teams that really, it's been 40 years for two of them, and one had never been there before. That's an intriguing Final Four, you think?
I'm telling you, it ain't no piece of easy cake to get there. If you get there, baby, you've done quite a few. I mean, every coach that I would think of, final goal is to get to the Final Four and win a national championship, and it just doesn't happen. You know, some coaches have struck a goal when they get a chance to go back-to-back and have the chance to win a national championship. We were one of those teams that went back-to-back. At Final Four, there's a lot of times in conversations we forget that the team that went the year before was almost the group that went back second time, which is hardly ever happened. So that's another thing that you got to look at, getting to the Elite Eight, Sweet 16. All those are very places that you have to get to in order to get to play in a national championship game.
What do you think of this Final Four? What do you think of those four teams that are there? Who can win?
Well, I said all along that it'll be teams that we have no clue will be there. However, Connecticut had proven from the beginning of the season, I watched them a lot because I remember Coach Anderson was in the same league with the Connecticut team. And they looked awfully good with the Big East. I thought the Big East had some very, very good teams in there, and that was one of them, Villanova. So you get an opportunity to watch other leagues play and how they play. You get a chance to watch how the games are called on the East Coast as compared on the West Coast. You know, there's a lot of comparisons that changes the style of play. You can see the style that some of them are wide open, which used to be everybody was closed down. But now you got a wide open game, and it brings a lot more interest to the game because it's a fun game to watch instead of a pattern-type game to watch. Those days I thought was over, but I see now that more and more teams are ripping and running and playing the kind of basketball that I enjoy playing and watching.
Well, that's interesting because when you look at Connecticut and Alabama, I heard a stat today, and you know there's stats for everything, and I know how you feel about stats, but Alabama obviously loves to run. Connecticut does not, and in only four games this year has Connecticut had as many as 70 possessions, and those were all routes against bad teams. So do you see Connecticut and Alabama as whose style wins could win the game?
With what style do you say?
Yeah, whoever sets the tempo, whoever's style carries the weight of the game, whether Alabama can run or Connecticut keeps them from running.
Right. You know, whoever can will their game on the opponent, the opposite team, to me is the one that's got a chance to be the winner. And if both of them are runners, both of them are shooters, I mean, there's got to be something to separate, and the separation becomes how many 50-50 balls do you get? How many touches do you touch? You know, it's a funny thing. Before 40 minutes, I guess, was invented, we always charted deflections. I mean, that was so important to my teams for deflections, because the deflection turns into a turnover in most cases. And so that's why we always talk about the hands. The hands, to me, you use, but the hands of other coaches, they come back with this idea that don't use your hands, move your feet. Well, if you don't move your hand, hell, you can't catch the ball. You got to use your hands to catch the ball. You got to use your hands for balance. You know, I said the key is how do you use your hands? And so. You can't play my style and not use your hand. I mean, that's why they hand check. Have you watched? They got hand check going on, and they never call it anymore.
Yeah, that's You're exactly right. You're right.
It's, you know, 3 seconds are going off. They never call that anymore.
Nope.
You know, the IC team's running we call it the short corner. They just go down and sit in the corner and wait, and the pass go in that corner, and I've never seen so many shots come out of the corners of a basketball gymnasium, but that's how they play this day and age. You know, it's not so much. There's more freedom on some teams to shoot the basketball. I was discussing with a guy the other day. I said, "What's better? A guy could come down the floor, and the first shot he got an open shot. He takes it. He misses." Then you yell at him, move the ball. And then he takes 15 passes, had the same shot, and he takes it and he misses it. So what's the deal? What are you moving the ball around for if you get the same shot 40 passes later that you missed on the first shot? Then that same guy who hits the first shot and makes it, and it's okay. No, nobody said, well, why wasn't that a bad shot? It was the same distance, and you had to – well, you know, there's so many interpretations of how to play the game. I think with Alabama, to me, I you have to give the edge to Connecticut. But I have a sneaky feeling that Purdue might win it all.
That big guy's hard to stop, isn't he? I mean, he is just a monster inside.
Yeah, he's a handful, and you know, and watching him, I've watched him like he grew during the season, or even going toward the end, he getting better and better and better. Most guys reach a peak, and that spot where they are, and y'all finish out. This guy here is getting like he ain't never played very much, and he done got better. How good can you get?
He's big. There's no question of that. Let's talk with Justin. Justin, good afternoon. You have a question or comment for the coach.
Yes, sir, and maybe all of the rest of you as well. I've been a Razorback. Well, I'm 50 years old, which means I've been a Razorback fan for 49 years and 7 months. And
I couldn't hear that.
I said I'm 50 years old, and which means I've been a Razorback fan for 49 years and 3 months or whatever. But I wasn't expecting to get to talk to you guys when Coach was on. And Randy, I've been listening to you from the beginning, way back in the early 90s or whatever. And Rick, I remember you on the football and everything. And Coach, I was a young man in your heyday, and all of y'all are big, y'all don't know me, but I know y'all.
Well,
and I wanted to say thank you to Coach for everything, a big part of my life, and Randy and Rick, you too. But I just have a question. After all we've been through together in the last 50 years, What do you think is the Arkansas Razorback basketball job today the best job in the country? And on any other given day, where do you think it ranks with all the rest of the college football jobs? And thank you. Love all y'all. And I'll listen on the radio.
Thank you, Justin.
Where do you rate Arkansas's basketball job today, Nolan? Is it still one of the best?
You know, I would always say that it is the best. I don't even have a job. I'm still living up there. So that got to speak loud. You got five, maybe I would say the top 10 jobs in the country. Arkansas has got to be in the top five of those top 10. As far as I'm concerned, how I see the Razorbacks as we progress, the biggest key is not so much facilities that it used to be the way to go is keep up with the Joneses. Nobody cares about the Joneses anymore. The kids don't care that much about the arena that they play in anymore. It used to be, boy, you go in that arena and wow. And it doesn't wow anyone because everybody's got basically a pretty decent arena to play in. But what do you do in those arenas? It has a lot to do with guys making decisions. But more than not in a job like the Arkansas, when you have all the new rules and the money that are going to, it's going to change recruiting drastically because now they don't care about nothing but the financial package about the school that they're going to end up going to. It's all about, it's not about the school facilities anymore like it used to. You know, we had a practice gym, well, you need one, and they need one, and this guy's got one, and we need, we don't have to keep up with the Joneses. Unless you can get the money purse scraped, then there is no Joneses. And that's but Arkansas ranked real high in my category of saying which is the best jobs in the country. Arkansas has got to be one of them.
Let's talk with Reverend Outlaw. Reverend Outlaw, you have a question or comment for Coach Richardson.
I got maybe two quick questions. I got to say thanks to you, Randy, and Rick. I appreciate y'all for, you know, giving Arkansas a voice and being able to, you know, express your opinion. Coach Richardson, as I was waiting online, I was thinking about how amazed I am just to be able to even talk to you. And it's just incredible. It's incredible because, you know, watching you on the, you came bigger than life with the way that you got the Razorback program. And I respect your opinion. And I can't even put it into words just how excited and thrilled I am to even have the opportunity to speak to you. So, but you made a comment.
Thank you.
A few days ago, you made a comment a few days ago that, you know, you like that movie Trading Places when the individuals were given the opportunity at a different way of doing things and how it could work. You know, I'm always, you know, amazed at the running gun style that you had, how it overcame a multitude of, you know, of, I guess, if the team had a weakness, you could always, you know, make up for it with that type of pressure. I think that Arkansas as well, and I'm glad to hear you say that Arkansas is one of the best jobs in the country. I'm glad that you took the job and glad that you were able to, you know, make it into what it is. I still believe in David and Goliath, and I think that, you know, if there is a coaching change, Arkansas, under the right guidance. And the other question I was going to have is, do you think there may be a coach at a smaller school that could come in and do that type of job? And with that, I just sit back and listen.
Thank you, Reverend.
Well, first of all, Rev, explain the run and gun, and I provide I talk to my players as run and execute.
That's right.
There's a difference between running and gunning and running and executing. Mm-hmm. And that's what we did. But because of the style of play, and no one is not used to that kind of basketball, it was run and gun. in my eyes, it was never considered. There was time we had five passes. There was time that it took 10 passes to get what we wanted.
But, Coach, we got to execute a timeout. We got to execute a timeout.
Hang on, Coach.
Okay. Keep thinking.
Your home for the Hogs and your ticket hookup. We have tickets to every Diamond Hog home game and want to give them to you. Listen each weekday for your chance to win from 103.7 The Buzz.
Listen to Out of Bounds every day to hear about what's trending on social media and whether listeners agree or disagree. Engaging conversations about engaging topics. Sponsored by Arkansas-based West Rock Coffee. Join West Rock and their 1.5 million coffee farmers around the globe as they fuel Arkansas with great-tasting coffee, tea, and water delivered directly to your business. Contact them at westrockcoffee.com or 833-886-JAVA. That's 833-886-5282. Call today.
Heart Royal Flush Tour 2024. Saturday, October 12th, Simmons Bank Arena. A journey through the hits and timeless classics. The iconic band returns with special guest Cheap Trick. Tickets on sale Friday at 10 a.m. at heart-music.com. Don't miss two Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductees. Heart with Cheap Trick live.
It's the Tracker Open House Sale at Bradford Marine and ATV at all six statewide locations. Check out the Sun Tracker Sportfish 22, great for fishing and cruising with a 115-horsepower Mercury outboard. It's the Open House Sale at Bradford Marine and ATV, your authorized Tracker dealer.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkopf, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkopf leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Are you ready for a better forklift experience? River Valley Tractor and Castle Forklift have teamed up to manage your material handling needs. From diesel, lithium, propane, and so much more, Castle's product line is versatile, ready for the next generation of consumers to make every job easier. Step into the future of forklift innovation. Choose Castle. Visit River Valley Tractor, your authorized Castle forklift dealers in Central Arkansas.
Are you someone who tries to drive while distracted by your phone? Someone who props it up on the steering wheel or peeks down at it for a glance? Or just scrolls and scrolls? If so, you could be the next person to get into a fender bender, get a ticket, veer off the road, or even cause a crash that kills you or someone else. Enough with the phones already. Put them down and pay attention, or pay the price. You drive, you text, you pay. Paid for by NHTSA.
Sanders Ground Essentials presents Belinda Mayo when she joins Morning Mayhem each Thursday morning. Sanders Ground Essentials, where great lawns start today. On the web at sandersground.com. It's Melinda Mayo each Thursday with Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish Studios, where it's much like any of the seven Eat My Catfish locations, minus the always fresh, delicious food options like the family pack catfish dinners. Often imitated but never duplicated, this is Drive Time Sports with Randy Rainwater on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. We'll be rejoined by the coach in a few moments. Need to hurry out to Guatney Chevrolet because they've been experiencing spring fever. I'm afraid the spring is about to turn into summer. Now, maybe not with the temperatures we've had the last couple of days, but they have been slicing prices like crazy on the 2024 Chevy SUVs. Now, you can get a 2024 Chevy Equinox LS for less than $24,000. How about $23,726? Or, if you need a little bit more room and power, a 2024 Chevy Blazer RS could be yours for as low as $45,355. Now, you can save a lot of money at Guadney Chevrolet in Jacksonville. Think of the Gregory Street exit right off of 16767, right basically in the heart of Jacksonville, and that huge American flag. And who knows how much money you can save until you go try. And that is at Guadney Chevrolet, because you never know how long this spring fever will last. Chevrolet, together, let's drive. Now, Rick, before Coach has a chance, an opportunity to finish up on the run and gun, or however you want to say it, talk about the Yvonne Richardson Foundation, please.
Well, the Yvonne Richardson Foundation has been going for quite some time, decades now, and it has done numerous great works for many, many, many people around the state of Arkansas and even outside the borders, usually for people who have medical needs. Sometimes it's their kids that can't afford transportation, can't afford a place to stay. Maybe it's a food need. There are all kinds of needs that they meet, educational needs. And again, this is Coach's. We got him this week and next week. Be a nice tribute to Coach Richardson if we could get some people to go to Gift Yvonne, GIFTYVONNE.com, and contribute to the Yvonne Richardson Foundation. You know your dollars will be very well spent.
And, Coach, you are kind of getting started on the philosophy of run and gun, but not
execute.
Really. Yeah, run and execute.
And he was also asked about the defensive pressure, so you can go from one right into the other.
Absolutely. If you look at a basketball court and the way it's played, you know, the team that scores the most points wins. The team that stops the other team from scoring the most points wins. So if you play both ends of the floor, you got a chance to win twice as many as just one end of the floor. Does that make sense?
Yes.
That's the theory behind let's push the ball going, and let's push ourselves on defense going and coming. So my chances of being able to win gives me a little bit better chance, and our guys, you know, play that way. You know, earlier there was talked about why the coach maybe paying attention to some other school or something. I remember one of the greatest advices that I got my first year at times was really bad. And that's why to this day, I think the world of Hatfield. I'll never forget, he called me in one day and we were down pretty bad. We couldn't play with the crap and we weren't winning anything. And he said to me, all the people that are worried and upset about what's going on today will love you tomorrow, and you will love them too. And so if you give them a chance, they will give you a chance. So, and I'll never forget those words. You give them a chance, they'll give you a chance. And I enjoyed Coach Hatfield's presence on that campus as much as anybody that you can imagine, that a basketball coach really cared and liked the football coach. They don't normally speak. He was very, very, very influential to me. And that's why I'm still here.
Wow, beautiful
guys
to hear.
Guys like him.
That is beautiful to hear. And he is one of the finest human beings I've ever known, that's for sure. Yeah.
Absolutely. All right, Coach, here's one for you from our live fan feedback from Mitch in Northwest Arkansas. He said, for Coach, would Coach rather play a game in Barnhill or Bud Walton Arena? Also, take a stab at Billy Packer just for fun. That would make me smile. What a great hour of radio with Coach.
How am I supposed to answer that?
Well, we'll start with Bud Walton or Barnhill.
You know, it's a toss-up, and the reason is because we got a bigger barn, I would call it. But there's no comparison when it came to the loudness. I think we got pretty good there a few times in Bud Walton. But Barnhill was like that every night.
Yeah,
I had a headache every night. every ball game, there was a headache. And so me and Wayne, one of my assistants, were talking here the other day or today, and we were talking about how the officials would cover up their ears because it got so loud. You know, like, oh, man, this place is going to blow open. And you just couldn't get it you just couldn't get it any louder. And that's why it was so hard for anybody. We could beat the Lakers in there. You know, we played a tremendous game against the number one team in Vegas who could beat the Lakers any day away up there. But we were able to play with them and lead them at half, and they had never been behind at a halftime in any game. So, but that Barnhill Arena was a booger bet.
Well, let's ask this one then. For getting the crowd involved, Jim Robkin or anybody else?
Oh, my God. How can you mention him? You can't mention Bud Barnhill without Jim Robkin.
No.
I mean, he orchestrated stuff that to this day probably would find him someone that can imitate and do the things that he did to encourage the fans to get after it. Boy, he did a magnificent job. I really love the Jim Rotkins and the things that he did for our basketball team.
So, Coach, tomorrow is 30 years to the day since the national championship. Is there anything, when you think about that, is there anything you've never shared about that moment or that time or that day that you'd love to say?
You know, it goes without saying some of the things that I had enjoyed as a coach. I saw the junior college national championship on TV the other day, the junior college national championship, and to see how those guys felt, I know that feeling. And I said, man, then I look at the NIT, and we won a national championship for the NIT. I know that feeling. And then when I go to the next deal, I've been to the NCAA tournament, and I won that NCAA tournament. And that's even bigger and better. So each feeling that you see comes with each game that I watch. And I said, God almighty, I can only imagine how they feel inside of putting out so much work and be able to be rewarded for the work they've done. And I said, look at me. I am blessed. Every step of the way, I was able to win a national championship at all the schools I worked. I can always go back to and then say, job well done, Noah.
Coach, I've always wondered, I know what was going on in my job in the media, because both at Charlotte as well as Seattle, I was actually doing Saturday and even Sunday shows because it was such a special event. What did you as a team, I know there was some practice involved, but what did y'all do? Because that, to me, I barely got off the air. You couldn't do it from the, I couldn't do it from the arena. I can't remember. I guess I did it from the hotel there in Charlotte, uh-huh. and then dashed to the arena. But I just can't imagine all the time that you have on your hand between winning on Saturday and then playing on Monday night. What all did you as a team do, or maybe even in some regards as individuals, to take up some of the time?
Well, we didn't really do anything any different than we try to do every day. I've always thought if you're doing, for example, we were a team that went to practice on Final Four day, and people would come in and watch us work out. But we worked out. They didn't come and watch us put on a show of dunking or a show of just this is what we do in drills. And, you know, guys get a chance to run drills. They feel good about themselves that the drill went well. I'm not interested in drills. We got to win a championship. We got to win a game. We got to play just like every practice gets you ready for the next game. And so that's how I saw it. And I think our guys, they probably hated it because they said, hey, we don't take no time off. This guy, we practice even when we already got to the Final Four. Yeah, we sure do. We don't take no time off. And wow. So I get a kick out of some of them when they approach me and tell me that I was crazy. And I said, well, hell, everybody knew that. Yeah. That's why I couldn't coach me.
Hang on, Coach. We got to take one more break. Hang on, Coach. That is Coach Nolan Richardson. Thanks again to Slim Chickens. Stop by. Say thank you for making this possible. Thank you to Slim Chickens for bringing us Coach Nolan Richardson. Drive Time Sports will continue in a moment.
Birch Tree Communities, providing care for individuals living with severe mental illness in their own supervised home environment. Their staff serves as a guide to members on their journey to independence in the community. If you have a client, friend, or loved one diagnosed with schizophrenia, schizoaffective or bipolar disorder, and are in need of assisted residential care, please contact Birch Tree Communities Admissions Department or online at birchtree.org. Birch Tree Communities, a place called home.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more at the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
Hi folks, it's Chris Zender here at Frank Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood. When you're in the market for a new Dodge Chrysler Jeep or Ram, we hope you give us a chance to earn your business. Here's some things to consider. Fletcher Dodge has been family-owned dealer here in Sherwood for over 25 years. We know how to take care of our customers to keep them coming back. Every Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram dealer pays the same price for their vehicles. It's the dealer that makes the difference. We'll give you the best deal up front. No haggling, no arguing. We make it easy to buy a new vehicle. And we'll pay you more for your trade-in. Compare our deal to anybody's, and you'll buy from us. Come see us today for the deal of a lifetime on new Dodge Chrysler Jeep or Ram. At Frank Fletcher Dodge, you always get the best price, the lowest finance rate, and more for your trade. And we promise you a hassle-free buying experience. We want to be your dealer for life. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Just tell us what you're looking for, and we'll make you a deal. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood, or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
It's Justin Acri for Serta Pro Painters, and if you're like me, this time of the year, I'm spending a lot of time at the house watching basketball games and baseball games, and then I also start looking around the house and noticing some paint on the wall might have cracked, or you might see some scuffs on the wall, and you want to get that updated. If that's the case at your house, you need to get Serta Pro Painters on the case today. SertaPro.com, that's Serta with a C. All you have to do is go to their website, and they will come over, give you a free estimate, and you can trust them to get the job done right, because they take pride in what they do. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. When it comes to choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
The Powerball jackpot from the Arkansas Scholarship Lottery is now more than $1 billion. So, what would you do if you won?
I'd buy a baseball team.
Ooh, I would definitely buy my mom a Tesla so that she can drive cool, look cool.
If I won a jackpot, I'll start a cooking school for the youth in the city.
Got your ticket? If not, visit your local lottery retailer for your chance to win the Powerball jackpot of more than $1 billion. This is winning. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, you feed your crave for sports by listening to Drive Time Sports. Much like you feed your crave at any of the 7 Eat My Catfish locations.
Drive Time Sports, tapped with refreshing sports opinion on the Buzz Radio Network.
As Arkansas's community bank, First Security helps people make life better for themselves and for other Arkansans. They focus on helping make our communities stronger. Every dollar that stays in the community helps the community through things like new homes and businesses, so other people can have better lives. If you want your banking dollars to do more good, check out First Security at fsbank.com. That's First Security Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender, only in Arkansas. That's First Security Bank. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater, joined again by...
It's time for Rollin' with Nolan on Drive Time Sports with Coach Nolan Richardson. Brought to you by Slim Chickens. There's lots of places to get chicken, but there's only one Slim's, serving Central Arkansas and now open in Cabot and Jacksonville.
And let's talk with Brian. Brian, good afternoon. You have a question or comment for the coach?
I do. I was one of the lucky fans that were able to be there and actually see us win that national championship. It was a funny story. A friend of mine called and said they had gone to the semifinal games and said, we've got you 2 tickets. And a friend, me and another guy loaded up and drove, got there about 2:00 in the morning and went to the game the next day. And my question is, After we won the national championship, I know the hotel was crazy with fans and players and everything. What did you do after that game?
Well,
that night?
I tried to go lay down. that was you know, we ate. We went to eat, after that, I was trying to make sure that I'd get into bed and get some sleep. I'd been up, seemed to me, more than 24 hours because it started going when we got to the Final Four. I was already worn out, but that was such a wonderful feeling that you just let it go by. I didn't sleep, so it didn't work. I thought maybe I would pass out, but. Yeah, I couldn't pass out. Too much fun was going on.
Well, I can tell you one thing you did, Coach. Because you didn't want to do it. You told me you wouldn't do it, but you did it anyway. You showed up at the hotel, and Roy Firestone was there and somehow convinced you to do an interview with him. Yeah. That's one thing you did.
Right. I didn't really care to do any interviews anymore at that time.
Yeah.
We had some problems with the way some of the announcement was going throughout the year, and I just say, well, I don't. But he convinced me that there's never been a team that hadn't been interviewed at, after winning a national championship, or this coach Yeah.
So I went on and volunteered to do the show. Yeah, you're right, Rick. That's one thing I did do.
I tell you, another thing was, and you were at least aware of this, both morning shows, Good Morning America and whatever CBS's is called, always got the national championship starting five the next morning. Well, they're on at like 7 in the morning. And so, yeah, you get back to the hotel. Remember,
right.
the game started at like 9:20 Eastern time, so they could be – and so you get back and they're celebrating. I don't know if any of them ever got any sleep. And all five of them, we got them there somehow, and they did one show. And as soon as you're finished with that one, you move to another couch, and there's the other network. And that's another reason nobody got any sleep till they got home.
It was a fun time.
You remember that really well, Rick.
Yeah. Well, I remember those things.
They just don't come. Yeah. I know. And as you mentioned, it brings back some great memories.
Well, I'll tell you another one, and this is, okay, so I love baseball. Anybody that loves baseball knows who Bob Costas is. Bob Costas was in St. Louis, and every national championship coach, after they won a day or two later, he got them to come to St. Louis to do a show with him. Coach Richardson said, no, I'm not going to St. Louis. He is the only coach that Bob Costas came to him. And Bob, I don't know if you remember that, Coach. He did an hour with you. He was running late for his plane. And you called the airport and told him to hold the plane for him. And they did. How about that?
Wow. Coach, I don't remember. I don't remember the next day. I don't remember on that following Tuesday. I don't remember you coming on Drive Time Sports. I remember asking Rick over and over again, you know, do I get Coach on at 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock? He never gave me a response. I still to this day wonder why you didn't come on Drive Time.
Randy, I love you, but that was Bob Costas.
After all these years, now we find out things that we should have found out.
Doggone it, Coach. If I could have talked to you, it'd have worked. I just didn't get a chance to talk to you directly. Brian, thank you so much.
Oh,
those are all such great memories.
I appreciate you guys.
Well, I can tell you, do you have another caller?
Memories,
if you don't, I'm
going to. Go ahead.
Okay, here's my confession. I broke an NCAA rule at the Final Four because, as you know, the day in between, so today would be the 30th year anniversary because it's the day between the games. The starting five, all of them do a press conference with the coach. And so, Coach, I don't know how you got back to the hotel, but Kevin Trainer and I loaded the five starters into a van, and they all were hungry. So we went through the Popeyes drive-thru.
Oh, my goodness.
And I paid the bill. So that was a violation. I didn't tell anybody about it, but I picked up the Popeyes chicken for our five starters.
The NCAA will now take away the trophy.
See,
I don't think so.
See, now it all comes. It's legal. It's all get out now.
Oh,
not
yeah.
He could have bought it.
Now they could have gone in, signed autographs, and each got $1,000 each.
Yeah, they could have went inside, autographed. They could do anything now. So, you know, I'm sorry that law is not binding for 40, 50 years.
That's true. Well, I can tell you, lunch at Popeye's was lots
lot,
less
Rick.
Then.
Thanks a lot, Fred.
Popeye's lunch cost less then than it does now.
Well, he was scared to turn the receipt into Coach to Coach Rules.
No, I wasn't going to do that.
Hey, guys, let me throw a
Those
quick.
Those were the good old days. Man.
Let me throw in this quick fact for you, for what it's worth. We've been talking so much, Coach, about the transfer portal over and over and over again. The Final Four teams, in regards to major contributions from transfers, North Carolina State has benefited the most. NC State has gotten 93% of their points from former transfers.
Wow.
Nearly 70% of the points scored by Alabama has come from transfers. Nine. That's nine transfers that are playing now for NC State, and Alabama has six. But 93% and just about 70%. So when you say the transfer portal can giveth and it can taketh away, I would say in this case the transfer portal has given a lot to NC State and Alabama. Coach, the one thing that about Connecticut, this footnote to Connecticut, they may be the best blend I think we've seen in a while that combines a high-scoring offense but can play tremendous defense. And I said that to lead into this, Coach. Have you ever, I know you had some great runs, have you ever been part, hopefully not in the negative way, but a 30 to nothing run?
Never. I can't imagine someone getting 30 to zero.
That was
unless
in the Elite
you
Eight.
A pickup game on the project.
That's right. I never thought of that. No, I've never beaten. I've never been beaten in a pickup game 30 to nothing either. Coach, have a great weekend. Final Four weekend. We'll talk with you next week. God bless you. Coach Nolan Richardson, thanks to Slim Chickens. Have a great rest of the night.
Your official sports and entertainment station, Central Arkansas. We are 103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
For Pulaski County residents and businesses, do recycling right by recycling old electronic equipment. How? Come to North.